And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
You know the bed feels warmer, sleeping here alone. You know I dream in color and do the things I want. You think you got the best of me, think you've had the last laugh, bet you think that everything good is gone. Think you left me broken down, think that I'll come running back. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. Footsteps even lighter. Doesn't mean I'm over, 'cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, stronger. Just me, myself, and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Kill you makes you stronger. Stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely when I'm alone. What doesn't kill you makes a fighter. Footsteps even lighter. Doesn't mean I'm over, 'cause you're gone. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger, stronger. Just me, myself, and I. What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Stronger, stand a little taller. Doesn't mean I'm lonely.
Bluefish were able to break down the York Revolution. Last night, it was all Derek Gordon, Andres Perez, and Chris Nowak as the Bluefish forced a game series three with the series tied at one. York won game two, Bridgeport won game one. The rubber match of the three-game series today from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. This edition of Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball is on the air right now. Perry Miles here with you, the Bluefish and the Revolution from the ballpark at Harbor Yard on this Wednesday morning affair. Many kids making their way out to the field for this camp day. Temperatures expected to get much hotter as the day progresses. Last night, it was a steamer. 100 plus degrees in the Connecticut area, and in Bridgeport, the summer time continued. The temperatures were in the 90s. York Revolution batters included Andres Perez and Chris Nowak. They stayed hot. Contributed 13 multiple RBI games of the season. And with the assistance of Derek Gordon on the mound with 8 innings of one-run baseball, the Bluefish were able to overcome certain obstacles in game one. They were not able to do that yesterday. Bluefish fell 4-1. Today, they will have Raymar Diaz going to the hill against a player who they really have had struggles against in Corey Thurman. Thurman has a 6-2 record since 2008 against the Bluefish with an ERA of about 2.5 and 6-3 overall against the Fish, which included the 2007 campaign, the inaugural season. Thurman, a former big leaguer, Raymar Diaz enjoyed plenty of success last year, not enjoying the same kind of success this year as his team is 2-9 when he goes on the mound. He's pitched a couple of better outings in each of his last couple of starts. 6 innings, 3 runs, 7 innings, 3 runs, and the Bluefish managed to win one of those two games. His problem all year has been the run support, his team giving him about 3 runs of support in his losses and a whole lot more than that in his victories. The Bluefish and the Revolution coming up in less than 20 minutes time when we come back on the Bluefish broadcast. We're going to introduce RJ Garcia and get you to starting lineups and first pitch. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
We believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles here with RJ Garcia. The Bluefish taking on the York Revolution in the final game of this series, as the Bluefish are hoping that they'll be able to come up with a series victory this afternoon. They have struggled against the York Revolution this season, going 7-9 in the previous 16 outings, and the Bluefish will have to deal with the York Revolution coming up in less than another week. They play another series against the Revolution during the week coming up on Tuesday, three times in that two-week span. RJ, how are you doing today?
I'm doing well, Perry. Another camp day, 11 o'clock start for the Fish and the Revs, and early travel day for York after the game.
I'm sure everyone is pleased about that, but also they're pleased because now their bodies can get acclimated to the adjustment in time.
Yeah, the 2 days in a row gives them that opportunity. The spots in between the night games, the one-day game, so to speak, it's kind of tough, but if you can kind of get on a routine 2 days in a row, we might see a little bit better baseball today.
Offensively, the Bluefish were unable to get the job done, but they have a series of changes to their lineup. Not necessarily the roster, their lineup. As we get to the starting lineups, Brandon Hovman leads off and plays right field today for the Revolution. Joe Thurston gets back into the order. He bats second and plays short. Ramon Castro, the third baseman, bats third, while Andres Perez, who came up with two doubles and two ribbies yesterday, bats fourth. Jeff Fiorentino is the designated hitter, batting fifth. Chris Nowak, who is the other big contributor, two home runs in as many games this series, he bats sixth and plays first. Left fielder James Shanks bats seventh and plays left field. Solomon Manriquez bats eighth and does the catching. And believe this, Scott Grimes is batting ninth and playing center field. After the way that he had performed over the last couple of years, never would we have imagined Scott Grimes batting all the way down in the lineup. He's supported by Corey Thurman, the right-handed pitcher, and he's had a great amount of success against the Bluefish in his career, 6-3 for the former big leaguer, with an ERA of 3.5, and since 2008, he's had a great amount of success. Same old stuff, 80-mile-an-hour fastball, 65-mile-per-hour changeup. The Bluefish have to be patient at the plate. He throws less than 50% strikes.
They're going to have to, and it's this lineup, which Perry mentioned, not many roster changes today, none, but shifting of the order. And that's going to start with the newly acquired again, Joey Gathright. He's getting a start out in right field. He's going to lead it off for the Fish. Eddie Rogers is playing short, 259 on the season. He's batting second. The DH today getting a little rest from the outfield with Gathright now in the mix. Prentice Redmond, he's batting third. Brock Peterson averaged up to 298 after a 2-for-3 effort last night, or yesterday afternoon, I should say. Perry's in the cleanup slot. Luis Lopez, third baseman, right behind him. And dropping down to sixth in the order, this is the mix-up, Kennard Jones, who has led off much of the year for the Bluefish or has batted second all the way down in the sixth hole. Behind him, Luis Rodriguez catching again 2 days in a row. 271 his average is. James Simmons, the center fielder, batting eighth, and he's up to 280. And Brett Doughty, coming back from his injury, is making now his second start since that, and he's rounding out the lineup, the second baseman, in hopes to give Raymar Diaz a little bit of run support this afternoon.
Series of changes that we talked about I believe that Luis Lopez is now going to see a few more pitches to hit. Early in the year, he was walking so many times. And he's never really had the support, the reinforcement. Not to say that Luis Rodriguez is a bad hitter, but if you're putting a 290 or 300 hitter who has the ability to drive in one runs the way that Jones has, it's much better for the fish. I always believe that Jones should be in the top two-thirds of the lineup. The question is where he should be. The leadoff hitter, yes, he steals some bases, but he drives in runs. If the Bluefish are able to get him to drive in more runs because Lopez gets on base, or he protects Lopez because Lopez protects Peterson, each of these guys is supposed to support each other. Kennard Jones now is that special reinforcement. Kennard Jones may not see as many fastballs, but he doesn't need to with his speed.
That's just it, Perry, and it's the driving in runs that you said. 43 of them this year for Kennard Jones. This is a leadoff hitter knocking in 43 runs. I mean, you can credit that a lot to the bottom half of the lineup with Simmons and Luis Figueroa of recent, who is sitting today getting the day off. But them getting on base has been able to give Kennard Jones that opportunity. Now dropping down into the lineup, there might be a couple more guys more frequently on base for him.
I'm sure the Bluefish are on their way to making a few more changes, but none of them are going to be made today as the Bluefish and the Revolution standing tall. Bridgeport's going to have to deal with some solid clubs in the second half, and the team that's coming in to the Park City tomorrow is a squad that has been reeling. Four straight losses for the Ducks. They're in last place in the Liberty. Bridgeport in third. The second place team is Camden and the River Sharks. They lost their contest yesterday to Lancaster by a count of 5-4. Southern Maryland, who has very solid pitching and no offense, the question is, when does Southern Maryland move down in the standings? When do they struggle to allow for Camden and Bridgeport to move up? Right now, Long Island is basically playing for the right to go to the championship because they don't have anything to worry about. They clinched the first half. They could go 0-70 or 4-66 because that's mathematically possible. They could conceivably go 4-66 and still have a spot in the postseason.
It's true, but realistically, nobody wants to do that. Nobody wants to go through the downs and hit the playoffs in a slump. And the Long Island Ducks seem to just trying to be working out the kinks with the deadline looming of making rosters set next month. They're trying to figure out the pieces of the puzzle that are going to be able to give them that championship.
Oh, of course they are. I'm not suggesting nobody would have that little pride to say, oh, we won the first half.
Right.
Let's tank it in the second half. Nobody's going to do that. But they're trying to work it out. And the one team that this reminds me of, the Long Island squad, their offense is still pretty good.
They are very good.
They remind me of the 2010 version of the York Revolution. They had very good pitching to start off. They had an outstanding offense, a record-setting offense throughout the year. In the second half, the first half, the York squad lost a few pieces that they could not overcome in the second half. They had to bring in a few pieces late, including Matt DeSalvo, to win the championship. They won with an under 500 record during the regular season. That, to me, is a little bit alarming. Long Island finished out with a 39-30 record, which is a very good record for half number one. You finish 9 games above 500, you wind up with 78 victories and 60 losses. It's a pretty good mark.
It's a good mark. It's not quite Lancaster Barnstormers mark, because they're rolling along, man.
Lancaster's rolling along, and they are on a record-setting pace. They finished at 45-25. If they go on that same pace in the second half, they will own the Atlantic League record for most victories in one season at 90. For those that remember, the Somerset Patriots had several records shared for quite a while, 87, 88 victories. Bridgeport, the one season that they performed really well, had that record-setting pace for one half, only had 83 wins, and they were one win higher than the Southern Maryland squad for the best mark in the league. Speaking of Lancaster, they lead their division by a game and a half over Sugarland in the second half, two games ahead of Somerset, and two and a half ahead of the York Revolution. Lancaster easily the best record in the league, nine games in front of Long Island. They are 52 and 29 as the Bridgeport Bluefish make their way to their respective positions. Raymar Diaz grabs the baseball from behind the mound. The kids are ready. The players will be ready shortly as we direct our attention to behind home plate, where we will introduce the umpiring crew. Today it's David Mills, first baseman Ronnie Whiting, and the third base umpire Marty Bauer. We are ready. Now we'll direct our attention further to behind home plate and the singing or the performance of the national anthem. Nice rendition of the national anthem performed. It is the organist version. It's almost as if they brought Madison Square Garden to the ballpark at Harvard Yard. Raymar Diaz hoping to come up with a gargantuan effort. The York Revolution support Corey Thurman with plenty of runs today, and they always seem to against Corey Thurman. But Raymar Diaz is on the hill, and he's not been getting as much run support for the Bluefish. Fastball, slider, changeup, that's what he'll feature. As last start, seven innings of work, three earned runs on 10 base hits with a walk and five strikeouts. And he, in his last two starts, has performed quite well, which includes the Sugarland game. The date on July the 15th against Long Island was actually out of the bullpen. So his last two starts have been pretty solid. They're looking to put him in the starting rotation because of what they saw last year. The consummate professional with very good stuff. But the problem with him has been his ability to follow through with his offerings. He does not quite go all the way through down. He leaves the ball up.
Just a little bit, and that has to worry the Bluefish, but Diaz has been pitching better, like you said, lately. So we'll have to see what he's got today. It's been control issues, but he has limited those walks of recent. His last four appearances, he only has three total walks, and then that's in about 16 innings of work. So that's pretty good there.
Can Raymar Diaz establish himself early against the Revolution? Because his resume against the Revolution speaks otherwise. Two losses in three starts against the Revs, 12 and a third innings, 15 earned runs, 18 hits, six walks, and six strikeouts total against the Revolution as Brandon Hovman leads off, followed by Joe Thurston and Ramon Castro. The right-hander Diaz waits, lifts his leg and fires. Fastball right down the middle, 0-1. Luis Lopez creeping in from the lip of the infield grass, expecting bunt from Hovman. He has provided that kind of speed. And Lopez fully aware. He's at the hot corner today. The 0-1, slap foul down the left side, no balls and two strikes. Lopez is going to move back a little bit now. Eddie Rogers is at short. Brett Doughty takes over for Luis Figueroa for today. Brock Peterson's at first. Machete occupies home plate. Kennard Jones, James Simmons, and Joey Gathright. First time we've seen Gathright in right field all season. The 0-2 is slapped foul to the left. No balls, two strikes. It's the first time that he's played since May 22nd with the Fish. After that, he was picked up by Cincinnati. He performed well with the Reds, but Reds no longer saw him as fitting for the big league level. Not going to fit with his team. The 0-2 chopped on the ground high towards short. Eddie Rogers corrals and fires quickly. It's in time. Beat the Purdue graduate by a stride, one away.
Great play by Rogers in betweener with Louis Lopez coming over. He decided to back off and let the sure-handed shortstop make the play.
It takes more than physical ability to play short. It's an understanding of how fast or how not fleet of foot a base runner might be. Eddie Rogers understands that most leadoff hitters in this league possess a great amount of speed. He knew he had to get rid of the ball quickly, and his release was priceless.
Hobman, one of the quicker guys in the game.
The one-out toss is a fastball over the middle, 0-1. Back. Joe Thurston had a couple of hits a couple days ago in his debut with the Reds.
Back-to-back first pitch strikes. First two batters Diaz has faced. Good sign so far.
The 0-1. Fastball stays outside. One ball, one strike. And what you notice is those baseballs are staying lower and lower in the zone compared with what the other strikes might have been in the past. He was keeping them elevated. The 1-1. Fastball, that one was elevated, but it was way outside the zone, 2-1.
Has to be promising for Raymar Diaz and the Bluefish. That last start that he had was against that potent, powerful Lancaster lineup. And, I mean, he went seven innings, only gave up three earned runs.
The 2-1 slides over the inside corner for a strike. Two balls, two strikes. He was aware of how much of a short porch it was in right. And in the interview that I conducted with him following that game, he said, you have to pitch differently in Lancaster because of the short porch. You don't want to get beat with an inside offering. You don't want to double up. 2-2. A high slapper towards third. Lopez grabs in fair ground and delivers a strike. Two away.
Good play by Louis Lopez. He knew that Thurston, not the most fleeted foot guy, he makes that play over the bag, he's got a good chance of retiring him at first.
Ramon Castro digs in. The Revolution have scored a run in each of the first two games of this series in the first inning. It has not mattered for the most part because the Bluefish won the first game due to bad pitching, bad execution by the Revs' starting rotation and Chris Cody and then the bullpen, which exacerbated the issue. The two-out toss, a fastball high, one ball, no strikes. Followed by the Bluefish tying the game in the bottom of the first, but Derek Gordon taking over.
Yesterday was his day. He started finding that groove. I believe it was 14 batters in a row before he left the game that he retired.
1-0 is smacked in the air to left center field. James Simmons jogs over and makes the play for the final out of the inning. A 1-2-3 set for the Revolution. The Bluefish are coming to bat in the bottom of the first. No score from the ballpark at Harvard Yard. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should,
yeah.
It's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together? Just like a good team. At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball returns from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Corey Thurman is on the hill for the Revolution. He has changed the face of this franchise in a number of ways. He lives in York full time. He's had a great record. He leads in many of the pitching categories for Revolution history. Quality starts, wins, game started, strikeouts. He's the best pitcher in York history, and he's a former big leaguer. Right-hander will have to take on former big leaguer Joey Genthright, Eddie Rogers, Brandon Redman, all three of them players in the major leagues. Genthright's his first game with the Bluefish since May the 22nd. He joined the AAA affiliate of the Cincinnati Reds, the Louisville Bats. Batted 299 with the ball club. Perhaps the reason why he was not called up was because he only had four stolen bases in six chances in the number of games that he performed. The first pitch on its way to Gathright leans on the outside corner 0-1. 299 with them, 240 when he left. Two homers and 13 ribbies.
Nine stolen bases here with Bridgeport, only caught twice.
The 0-1, slap foul. No balls and two strikes. Thurman features a fastball at 80 miles per hour, a changeup at 65. He could even go slower than that if he chose. At one point, he was able to toss a 95. But age can do a number on any pitcher. The 0-2, fastball high, one ball and two strikes.
It just shows you can be successful in professional baseball at this level, knowing how to pitch. Where to place.
The 1-2. A high pop down the left side, but it drifts out of play onto the York dugout. One ball and two strikes. Let's take a quick look at the defense for the Revolution. Ramon Castro's at third. Joe Thurston's at short. Andres Perez occupies second. Chris Nowak's at first. Solomon Manriquez is behind home plate for Corey Thurman. James Shanks, Scott Grimes, Brandon Hoffman from left to right in the outfield. Setup from Enriquez is outside. The 1-2, he did go, according to the home plate umpire David Mills, for the strikeout. Gathright goes down, one away.
Tough break for Joey. Looked like he tried to hold up, and it looks like to me that he did, but Mills thought otherwise, and that's a strikeout to start Corey Thurman's day off.
Eddie Rogers steps up to the plate. The way that these pitchers are able to execute their offerings and the way that Gathright was able to hit around 300 the entire time, the prospect pool in AAA might be better, but is the competition really that much better? Some may disagree with that premise. The one out toss is on the inside corner 0-1, especially with Atlantic League play.
Good competition here, really some of the best if you want to compare it to AAA level, but the premise behind it all is to win, Perry.
The 0-1, fastball inside, one ball and one strike.
A lot of times when you get into the affiliated ranks, those guys are out there trying to get better personally, not as a team.
The 1-1, line drive past third on a humpback, the shortstop throws across, and it's not in time. Thurston had a strong arm, but it was beat out by Eddie Rogers. He extends his hit streak. He had a hit yesterday and eventually scored the only run of the night for the Bluefish as Prentice Redmond steps forward. Those are the kind of hits to expect from Corey Thurman. Those jam shot three hoppers to the left side of the infield. He'll throw a changeup off of his original changeup. So instead of going 65 to 68 miles per hour, he'll go 55 to 58, which is even worse because it throws off the timing tremendously. And then when you get to the bullpen, they're throwing gas at 92. The one out throw to first is not in time. It almost sounds unfair. It's like facing a knuckleballer. See how often R.A. Dickey got hit in the first half of the year.
Not there. It's tough to pick up on speeds that these professional players are not used to seeing.
Prentiss Redmond steps up. Thurman deals. Pitch. Appear to be a fastball high. One ball and no strikes. Fastball, changeup, slider, and curve. But with the velocity on his pitch, it's very difficult to tell which one is which. Unless it's a floater, then you know it's a change.
Redmond 0 for 4 yesterday after a 3 for 4 performance the night before. Looking to pick it up with a couple of hits.
Thurman steps off the rubber before he reestablishes his presence on the mound. He always tries to keep base runners close, but with how fast his baseball gets to home plate and his delivery, it may be better suited for him to try to alter his rhythm rather than try to hurry it up. The throw to first is not in time. He's not going to hold too many base runners.
No, just trying to keep him honest there. If he lets him know that he's well aware of Rogers, might keep him at bay a bit.
Thurman stalls the leg lift and the pitch. Fastball away, two balls and no strikes. Less than 50% of his pitches are strikes. The Bluefish are aware of this, but for whatever reason, over the last few years, they cannot help themselves. They look so good, and then they flatten out about 6 inches off the corner. The runner goes. The pitch is high. Throw to second. Not in time. The throw hopped to the right spot on the bag, but the tag could not be applied in time by Andres Perez. Eddie Rogers with double-digit stolen bases.
That's his 11th back-to-back games with a stolen base. Rogers looking like he's aggressive, exactly what Willie Upshaw wants to see out of his lineup.
And with one man out, Prentiss Redmond has an opportunity to give the Bluefish the lead with a single. Eddie Rogers possesses a great amount of speed as indicated by his stolen base totals.
They're climbing and much more of late, but so are the Bluefish.
3-0. Fastball down the middle, 3-1.
The Bluefish in general, Perry, seem to be stealing and more aggressive on the base paths with trying to get runners into scoring position and eventually crossing the plate.
3-1 from Thurman. Elbows jilted down the pitch. Check swing did not go around. Redmond walks. Thurman has allowed 32 walks and 89 in the third innings, which is a little bit higher than the average of 3 walks every 9 innings that a pitcher is expected during his starts. But he's really limited the walk totals in his last 4 starts. Only one time has he given up 3 walks in a game, and that occurred at Camden on July the 20th. He walked 3, but it was in 6 2/3 innings. Before that, only had 1 walk in his previous 3 outings. So he's learned to control his pitches a little more after he was trying to work out the kinks early. Against Bridgeport earlier this season, 11-1 victory. He gave up 3 walks, the 1-out toss, a fastball staying high, 1 ball and no strikes. The Bluefish, Brock Peterson, he's been on fire. 2 hits yesterday, and he had an RBI. He has a chance to put the Bluefish ahead. Bridgeport has not been ahead by much in this series, just 1 inning. But it was enough to grab that victory in game 1. Next toss over the middle. Count 1 ball and 1 strike. The defense is aligned towards left center field with Scott Grimes. James Simmons playing about midway in left and Brandon Hoffman. halfway and right. The 1-1. Swung on and driven to deep left. Going back is the left fielder Shanks. He's at the track, stops, and makes the catch just in front of the Have Your Picnic Here sign for out number two. Brock Peterson sent a long fly ball, but the wind is driving more towards right center field and slightly in from left, which may mean Peterson's going to have to drive it even better than that to send it over the wall.
And he hit that pretty good. You heard the crack off the bat, maybe just off the end of it, but Peterson had his eyes wide when he saw that pitch and thought he might have got his 20th home run of the season.
And Thurman understands that he may not be able to throw that pitch anymore as Luis Lopez stands in. He's 2 hits shy of 2,100 for his career. Righty versus righty. Lopez stands in with his knees slightly flexed. The runners go. The pitch is outside. The throw to third. Not in time. It goes off the base runner, but unable to identify it was Eddie Rogers. He did not realize where the ball was. Had he realized initially, it would have been 1-0 Bluefish. While skittered about 10 feet beyond the lip of the infield grass, the closest one to the baseball was Joe Thurston at short.
Willie Upshaw making things happen over there, third base coach, the manager of the Bluefish. He figured, hey, if we can get a stolen base here, double steal, Luis Lopez gets a single, that's two runs, not one.
And Lopez confident in his ability, 275 on the year. He's been teetering between 270 and 280 the entire season. 1-0 is low, two balls and no strikes.
And here's where we might see the evidence immediately with Kennard Jones batting behind Luis Lopez. Yes, he's down 2-0. But like you said, Thurman, less than 50% of his pitches, four strikes. So it's not uncommon for him to be missing the zone like this. So we'll see even with Jones waiting on deck.
With Lopez at the plate, Castro is playing a little bit off the bag at third. The 2-0 lines up low on a change, three balls and no strikes. No baiting from the Bluefish. The middle infielders, Thurston short and Andres Perez at second, they're playing more towards the middle of the diamond, and they will just walk Lopez to set in motion for Kennard Jones. Winds up being an intentional walk after three outside the zone. Mark Mason making his way to the mound to discuss matters with Corey Thurman. And first baseman Chris Nowak is playing off the first base pad.
Big, big spot, Perry. Kennard Jones didn't get a chance to talk to him about his shift down to the six hole. But anyway, he's in the lineup, and I know he's happy about that.
There is going to be a rotation of players these days to give the Bluefish some rest out there. Joey Gathright has a great amount of speed. He can play any outfield position. He's done so in his big league career. Prentice Redmond, he can play right, center, or left. James Simmons, though, is the main piece in center field at this point, unless he needs a day of rest. He's been providing a great amount of power. With Jones up at the plate, Thurman cannot afford to nibble. The two-out toss, swung on and missed. That pitch dove out of the zone. That was not a strike.
That was a great changeup to start Kennard Jones off. He was anticipating fastball. Get ahead, stay ahead is what Jones thought, and Thurman did too, except he fooled him with the changeup.
The 0-1 on its way from Thurman to Jones. Even stance from the left-handed batter, the 0-1. A high pop to the left side. That time he was anticipating changeup and just lifted it foul.
Castro's playing pretty close to the edge of the infield grass. He knows the left-handed hitter is a slap hitter. If he goes to that left side and a ground ball there, he'll be able to gobble up.
Grimes playing a little bit less towards left center than he normally does for Jones because he understands what kind of velocity Thurman throws with this stage in his career. The 0-2 swung on and served towards Scott Grimes, who makes the catch. Played almost perfectly for the final out of the frame. The Bluefish leave three runners on base at the end of one. Bridgeport and York are scoreless. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we believe if you're not choosing a light beer with more taste, you need to man up, not man down. Because up is way better than down. You don't tell someone sad to cheer down. What's down, dog? A steamy pile and you just stepped in it. Your girlfriend's not wearing a push-down bra. It's called gravity, Isaac Nitwit. Can I be down front with you? All this down talk is bringing me down. So don't man down, man up, and choose a light beer with more taste. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, grumpy pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple Hops Brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Bridgeport Bluefish baseball returns from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The Bluefish and the Revolution are scoreless. Raymar Diaz was able to retire the Revs in order in the first inning. The Bluefish had their chances. They walked twice in the first and could not score against Thurman. That bend but do not break style has fit him throughout his Revolution career. The first pitch is a fastball inside, 1-0 to the former Bluefish player. Thurman is third, for that matter, in the Atlantic League in career victories, which is why he's done as well as he has. Diaz hoping to reach that. Pitches grounded over to second. Bobbled for a moment by Dowdy, but he recovers and goes to first. One away. Assuming that Diaz does not get picked up by an affiliated organization, anything's possible, right? Think so.
Anything's possible. You never know in this game, I'll tell you that, at the flip of a switch.
Joey Gathright, a few years ago, had been scuffling at the plate so badly that he went to the NABL with Yuma and then wound up in Triple A Pawtucket. The one out pitch is on the inside corner, 0-1. The Atlantic League is a much better league than the NABL would be considered, yet Gathright, because of his experience and because of his prowess there, pitch is swung on and missed, 0-2. He was able to get back.
You have to be willing to adapt to your situation and your scenario. Every path of one of these professional players is totally different, and at any point, things can click.
Diaz is 0-2. Fastball stays high, 1-2.
For Gathright, I don't know if he's too thrilled about right field. Said he hasn't played right field since 2004. Two times in his career, that's it.
Well, he has played all three outfield positions. The 1-2 settles low, 2-2. And with James Simmons out there, playing as well as he has, Gathright may have to get acclimated with the corner outfield spots.
It's true. Simmons covers a lot of ground in center field. Not to say that Gathright doesn't, but it's a different style. As we talked about, Simmons has those long Olympic-style strides.
2-2, way outside, 3-2. Gathright has so much speed out there with Simmons. It may be the fastest combination of corner outfielder and center fielder that the Bluefish have.
And we're forgetting about Kennard Jones. I mean, he's quick in his own right. 20 stolen bases this season. He can cover some ground.
3-2. Slap foul to the left. Count remains 3-2. We talk about the best outfielders or the best outfielder combination in the game. Lancaster's combination of Lentini, Godwin, and
Galen.
That's right. And then you add Harvey to the mix with his great arm and his prodigious power. That is a Corsum to be reckoned with. Pitches slipped and foul to the left side.
A different force to be reckoned with, I think. Their power and average numbers are right there. Not to say that Bridgeport's outfield foursome can't contend with it, but it's just a different style of players.
A different style, yes.
Yeah. They depend on those outfielders to do different things than this team depends on these outfielders.
The 3-2, slapped in the air to left field. Kennard Jones races over but cannot get it on the fly as he has to field it on the hop. The throw to second base goes into Brett Doughty. It is a single for Fiorentino as it brings up Chris Noah.
Fiorentino has hit the Bluefish well this series. He had a run yesterday and really playing out of this world.
First base, number 38.
Getting on for this guy right here, Chris Nowak, that has done the damage for the Revolution thus far in the first two games.
Chris Nowak steps up to the plate, righty versus righty, as Diaz holds the glove up, elbows jilted down. The slide step pitches yanked down the left field line. It is a base hit and rolls towards the corner. Rounding second and heading for third, Fiorentino. He's being held up by Inoel Polanco, the third base coach for the Revolution. Runners at second and third with one man out for James Shanks. Nowak has been hitting the Bluefish all too well, and he might wind up in the cleanup role rather than the sixth spot at some point. He's been there for much of the season.
The lineup's rolling the way it is. Not sure you should switch it up because it's not like Andres Perez has not been productive in the cleanup role. He had two RBIs yesterday.
That's true too. Last year's championship team, Nowak was the cleanup hitter the entire season. And the championship pedigree, along with the fact that Nowak was struggling, pushed Nowak down. The EO was at 1.5 for 39 after he rejoined the team from Mexico. The first pitch lines up inside, one ball and no strikes. It's not as if the lineup gets any easier. James Shanks is a prodigious power hitter, and Solomon Manriquez was just in an affiliate ball club. The 1-0 from Diaz. The toss waved at for a strike as it skips to the right. Luis Rodriguez stares at Fiorentino, making sure he does not go any further.
This is Diaz's turn. Saw Thurman last inning get out of his own jam. Now Raymar's got two runners on in scoring position, but he has to deal with one out. A fly ball could score Fiorentino. He's pretty speedy at third.
1-1, timeout is called. Talk about the number of changes that the Bluefish have had, the number that the York Revolution have had. The 1-1, slap foul to the right, a ball and two strikes. The baseball deadline is coming up for Major League teams, and there have been a number of changes. We talked about Omar Infante and Anibal Sanchez. Well, the latest big name to go by the wayside is Hanley Ramirez. He's going from the East Coast to the West Coast. 1-2, slapped down the right field line and a play, a ball and two strikes. The Marlins would like to trim salary after investing all that money. I was saying yesterday, if they're going to trade Omar Infante and Anibal Sanchez, well, why not trade Hanley Ramirez and Giancarlo Stanton?
And we were jokingly saying that.
We were jokingly saying that, and suddenly the Marlins traded him.
Unreal. I think it's also not only the salary issue, but a personality issue.
They invested all that money in Hanley Ramirez and all of these other guys to come in for the new ballpark.
Some guys need fresh starts, and teams need fresh starts.
The 1-2. Slapped on the ground towards Diaz. He flips it to home. It is in. No, not in time. Rodriguez pointing at the plate. He blocked it and spikes the baseball in dismay. David Mills not going to agree with the call. Luis Rodriguez cannot believe it. Willie Upshaw claiming that was the case. You can see a mark of dirt on the lower left diagonal of the plate. And that was where the slide was. The question was whether or not the tag was applied in time. There was no way to determine from this angle whether he was out or safe. I could not tell. Could you?
I believe he was safe. As much as they are arguing Diaz's throw was a bit high for Rodriguez, forced his body up. Fiorentino was able to get underneath. Rodriguez had to reach for it and then come back down. And by the time he came back down, there was no question that Fiorentino was at the plate. The question was, did he clip the plate on the way by?
And it appears, based on the way that the plate is, that a little section of it is covered with dirt. Whether the cleat touched the plate in the process of the slide is another situation. We'll have to ask Louis Rodriguez or Willie Upshaw what the explanation was from David Mills. But the Revolution have a 1-0 lead. And I believe because he was safe, that's got to be an RBI single. Diaz had no other play.
It's either that or a fielder's choice right now. There hasn't been a hit on the board. I think Diaz did have a play at Shanks at first. It was hit just in front of the plate, but well enough for him to field up and make a play. The only play he had was home trying to get that runner, but unsuccessful.
The one-out pitch on its way from Diaz. Slides inside, 1-0 and no strikes. That is a tough play for any umpire to make. The ball beat him, but the throw was a little off on the underhand toss. Naturally, players or even people throwing underhand is the right way to do it. It hurts your arm less. The pitch is inside on the corner for a strike, 1-1. It's not as if many players have qualms with David Mills. In your eyes, he's one of the best umpires out there.
I think you made a great call right there. And I also like Louis Rodriguez behind the plate, bluffing down to James Shanks. Diaz is paying no attention to him at first. Rodriguez wanted to know he was.
1-1, a high chopper towards third. Lopez flips the second one onto first off the bag. Another RBI. Lopez could have gone home to try to get Nowak. He opted to try to turn two, and instead another run comes across. It's 2-0 on a fielder's choice, 5-4. Solomon Manriquez with the RBI.
Hopefully Doughty's okay at second. He's coming back from that torn hamstring injury. He got taken out pretty good, and maybe not all the strength is there as the throw was a little bit off of the bag because it wasn't as strong, and it forced Brock Peterson off of it.
Solomon Manriquez is over at first base for Scott Grimes. Co-MVP 2 years ago, bottom of the lineup now. Pitch, fastball in the outside corner. Oh, 1-1. Go figure. Grimes at 239.
I personally think, Perry, that this makes their lineup much more well-rounded. Don't think it was a move because he's struggling, but it might have played a factor. I think they're just trying to mix things up as well.
0-1, slides outside. Down 1-1.
He had a double in the first inning yesterday off of Serafini. That's when the wind was carrying well out to right field, and that ball just kept on carrying and carrying and carrying over Redmond's head, but he was in the two hole.
So strange to see him not at the top. Pitch inside, 1-1 becomes 2-1. With two men out. Brandon, of course, if you have a guy like Brandon Hovman, who is a typical leadoff hitter with his speed and his ability to slap the ball to all fields and get on base. And Joe Thurston, who has much more professional experience than Scott Grimes does. Both of them have at least AAA experience. Grimes, the highest he's been is low A. And perhaps the quality of pitchers has improved, which has prevented Grimes from really getting picked up by an affiliated organization. He has not been able to hit the quality of pitchers this year that way that he did a couple of years ago. The next toss is on the inside corner, 2-2.
The crazy part to me, Perry, is you say the highest they've been, and it's low A ball, high A ball. If you ask me, this is the highest they've been. It might not be affiliated baseball, but this is the best competition, if that's the case.
You're accurate on that. The 2-2 stays upstairs, 3-2. But there are a number of players that also interchange that have rookie league experience or even college experience, like Joe Pilecki did for the Bluefish.
Right. But as far as competition-wise, very strong here.
The runner goes from first. The pitch swung on and missed for strike three. Down goes Grimes to end any other problems the Bluefish might face, but Diaz gives up two runs on two base hits, one runner left on at the end of an inning and a half. York with a 2-0 lead. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you listen to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
A poem entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice-cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Beer garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's going to be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, frost-brewed Coors Light. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
The Bluefish had their chance in the first inning and were unable to capitalize. The Revolution had their opportunity to take advantage, and the Revolution exploited Diaz and some of the defense for two runs in the second inning. The Bluefish trailing by a score of 2-0, heading into the bottom of the second with Luis Rodriguez stepping up. He's followed by James Simmons and Brett Doughty, 7, 8, and 9 in the order.
It was really a tough break for Raymar Diaz. Made a good play getting to that slow nubber in front of the mound. Just unfortunate that the call didn't go their way, and I think he was definitely safe. You got to credit David Mills. He was right on top of it, and all of a sudden, two runs later.
The first pitch on its way from Thurman is a fastball high, one ball and no strikes. He's still not throwing strikes. The Bluefish have to be especially patient and allow Thurman to get himself down in the count just like he is right now, 2-0 on the fastball to the dirt.
When you're dealing with a veteran pitcher that knows this league and knows these batters, he's going to nitpick a bit.
When I asked Willie Upshaw, I said, you don't want to face Thurman right now, right? He's like, no way. We want to face Thurman. The 2-0 is a fastball on the outside corner, 2-1, because he feels that his veteran team's going to be patient enough to be able to draw the walks, to have the opportunities to exploit either him later in the contest or his bullpen. The 2-1, grounded towards the middle, base hit, center field. Luis Rodriguez is on with a second base hit of the day. Sets up James Simmons. But the Bluefish, they have shown almost no propensity to execute what they preach against Thurman.
They preach to go out and get pitches, and now you have to reverse your style with a guy that doesn't throw a lot of strikes, right?
Except they are preaching, stay tight, let the pitches roll. Do not swing until he is down in the count, which he was there, and he gave up a hit. They preach it, yet they seem to attack his pitches every time. The next toss on the outside corner, 0-1.
Rodriguez took out a little frustration on that single up the middle, no question about it. He's got back-to-back days in his first at-bat getting base hits.
I'm sure Willie Upshaw has been frustrated because as intelligent of a pitcher as Thurman is, the pitch has popped up to the left side of the infield. Ramon Castro drifting to foul ground, has room and makes the catch. That's a perfect example. James Simmons chased a high changeup that, yes, would, for normal pitchers, be a batting practice fastball. For Thurman, it's slower than a batting practice fastball. You're going to be way out in front.
And there he was, and chances are that high changeup was going to be out of the zone. But the difference on that at bat was Thurman started Simmons with a first pitch strike on the inside part of the plate. So
that
he felt
true.
He had to get that pitch. He didn't want to get down 0-2.
Brett Doughty steps up to the plate. He may not be as familiar with Thurman as others, because Thurman's been in the Atlantic League for all this time, and Doughty was in affiliated baseball for a prolonged period of time. The one-out pitch slides inside, one ball and no strikes. A lot of times when players go to a college for 4 years, the way that he is, a family-oriented guy, when you go for 4 years, you do not face others from other parts of the country, whether it be high school or college, because you're not facing them in the College World Series. There are very few out-of-conference battles, and Thurman didn't even go to college. The 1-0 toss is on the outside corner, 1-1. He was drafted.
Some guys choose different routes. It all depends on what it is and how high you're drafted. Do you like the team you got drafted by in your position that you did, or do you want to go get an education?
1-1. Slapped in the air towards second. Perez jumps and gets the ball. Two away. It is a soft L4. It was a jam shot. You're not going to be able to do that much against Thurman unless you really get charge of a fastball right, towards the middle of the plate. Because his fastball is similar to a changeup down the middle, which is why he has to nibble.
Very carefully placing the pitches where he wants. Got to work the black.
It is a confounding thought to see a pitcher in this league, the Atlantic League, as the pitch is served in the air to left center field, stays high enough for the sliding play. The dive by Grimes to record the final out of the inning. It is confounding to see a pitcher like Corey Thurman be able to succeed with an 80-mile-per-hour fastball and a 65-mile-per-hour changeup without letting certain pitches go. And the Bluefish get one hit in the frame but cannot score. The Bluefish are down 2-0 at the end of two. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
The YP.com website is your local search engine. If you're looking for a good restaurant, it can help you find the right one nearby with ratings and reviews. Or if your car breaks down, you can use the YP app to find the closest repair shop. Or maybe you're just looking for something to do on a Friday night. Well, it has great local coupons for all sorts of things in your area. No matter what, when, or where, if you're looking for something, YP Local Search can help you find it. So go to YP.com or download the app to search local, find local, and save local.
The Gear Shop at the ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop, perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
Unless there was a sun shower on the field, I don't think there are any clouds. There are no clouds here. The grounds crew is taking care of some business at this point.
Well, the field tends to puddle a bit behind shortstop. Had some rain last night. And when you water down the field, it's a morning game. You know, didn't get proper time to dry. And you always got to water down the infield dirt before the game. And it must have just soaked in there, and the players might have been complaining a bit about their footing back there. And sure enough, a little dry rub, and we're going to move on.
The Bluefish's Raymar Diaz is on the hill. They used to throw his warm-up tosses. The diamond dry is done. Work complete. And I'm sure the Bluefish right-hander Raymar Diaz would like to get off to a better start than he did in the second inning. He induced a 4-3, but then it gave up a couple of extra base hits. And then his defense may have let him down a bit as well. Just two hits in the inning, but there were a couple of fielder's choices which led to two runs scoring. I believe it is an RBI. The first pitch is outside and low, one ball, no strikes. I believe Shanks gets an RBI, and Manriquez definitely got an RBI on the fielder's choice.
Have to see if he gets rattled. Raymar Diaz pitched so strong in the first inning, really still was pitching well in the second, just a couple bad breaks.
1-0 is lifted in the air, foul ground, giving chase Rodriguez, but it falls three rows back. One ball, one strike. Brandon Hovman sent a high chopper towards short. Eddie Rogers made a nice play on the baseball to hurry and deliver a quick strike. Brandon Hovman, a Division I athlete, his wife, a Division I coach for cross country. New one at the University of Dayton, the 1-1, fastball elevated, two balls and one strike. And many times coaches are removed because of a lack of success, so much invested financially with those types of positions, the same way that affiliate organizations have so much invested with their first and second round draft picks. The 2-1, slapped, base hit, left center field. First base hit of the game for Hovman as Joe Thurston makes his way to the dish. Other pieces of news for the Philadelphia Phillies, they signed Cole Hamels. $144 million deal, which means nobody is going anywhere from Philadelphia as far as their pitching staff goes. Phillies were looking to possibly trade him and then go after him to re-sign for the offseason. But Cole Hamels has been one of their best pitchers. Cliff Lee seems to be the guy that has underachieved due to a lack of offensive performance from his own team. Next toss, fastball high. Rodriguez could not quite throw it down to first as he lost grip of the baseball. 1-0.
Diaz has to do a better job keeping an eye on those base runners on first. Hovind is quick and stutter step. Bluff the steal attempt. Rodriguez is trying to keep him as close as he can, but without Diaz acknowledging him, it's tough.
Throw to first is not in time. One other piece of news that may be interesting, Wandy Rodriguez, who is one of the best pitchers for the Houston Astros, he's now a member of the Pittsburgh Pirates. Go look at them competing for the division title. 1-0, a high pop to the infield. Charging forward, Brett Doughty closes the glove with two hands, one away.
You could tell that Pittsburgh wants to win right now, Perry, if that's the case, just as the Tigers do by giving up one of their best pitching prospects for that Omar Infante, Anibal Sanchez trade.
Have you looked? The Pirates, they're only 2.5 back of the division, and they are in a wild card spot. The new rule in Major League Baseball is the 4 and 5 ranked teams, the two wild card teams, will duke it out in a one-game playoff to determine who makes it to the postseason to take on the number one overall seed. And right now, that would be the Washington Nationals. The one-out toss, the runner fakes going, and the Bluefish are in the middle of a rundown. Great play by Rodriguez, the fake throw, and the tag is applied. Great maneuver by the Bluefish. Rodriguez threw down to Peterson, spun around to Rogers covering. And Rogers applied the tag as he bluffed the throw back to the first baseman, Peterson.
You're not going to do that on Machete. One too many times he bluffed the pitch before in the previous at bat. That time Rodriguez gunned one down to Peterson.
The worst decision in baseball is indecision.
Hesitation, exactly.
Brandon Hovman did that. The next pitch is on the outside corner, one ball, one strike. He bluffed going. By the time he bluffed going, he was about 40% of the way down from first, and you can never do that against Rodriguez.
It's actually similar to soccer. I was playing goalie as a, you know, little league soccer or whatever.
Going one. Upstairs, 2-1.
And one of my coaches, one of my good friend's dads, told me, either you go or you don't go, as you want to go charge, you know, a close ball in the box. Either you stay put or you don't. Don't go back and forth. Don't waver. And that was exactly what he did.
2-1, slap foul to the right.
Except between bases and not trying to save a ball.
It is interesting to see, though, how difficult it is when someone is that close to kick the soccer ball into the goal, how many saves the keeper makes every time. 2-2. Chopper to short. Rogers collects on two hops, throws to first to retire the side. The Bluefish retire the Revolution in order. There was a hit, but that runner eliminated because of the arm of Louis Rodriguez. The Bluefish trailing 2-0 at the end of 2.5. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Miller Lite. We know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
Bridgeport Bluefish baseball is back. Perry Miles with R.J. Garcia. Eddie Rogers steps up to the dish. His second plate appearance of the day. He's 1-for-1. Followed by Prentice Reddy, Brock Peterson, 2-3-4, 2-up for the home team. Bridgeport in their teal uniforms or white bottoms with the Revolution in their same yellow and royal blue, the Revolution insignia across the chest in calligraphic style. Gray bottoms as well. As Rogers stands in, the first pitch on its way from Thurman. He winds and deals, first pitch, clips the outside corner 0-1. If Thurman is able to get that pitch on a consistent basis, he's going to be grooving, because that pitch appeared to clip the left-handed hitter's batter's box. The next toss, fastball inside, 1-1. Of course, he's not getting as many inside corner pitches as he is outside corner. Umpire may be having a little bit skewed view because the catcher's blocking that angle. Not his fault. 1-1. Upstairs, 2-1.
Each umpire is totally different with their strike zone. Yes, there's a general area, of course, across the plate. It's going to be a strike, but some guys waver a bit outside or a bit inside and kind of give pitchers benefit of the doubt if they can be consistent with hitting that spot. Not often do you see it going both ways on both sides of the plate.
The next toss, swung on and missed. Another off-speed delivery from Thurman. A steady dose. You almost might as well call him the doctor. He provides the cure for the Revolution.
8-2 on the season. He's provided it a couple times, huh?
4.53 ERA, not too bad. The 2-2 outside. 3 balls and 2 strikes. 7 of his last 10 starts. Quality starts.
He was an all-star as well. 2 innings and a strikeout and a hit in the all-star game for the winning team.
3-2. Waved that for a strike. Another changeup. Filthy one from Thurman. But Eddie Rogers swung at 2 pitches that were way out, that appeared to end up way outside the zone. And the Bluefish need to avoid that.
If you're letting Corey Thurman dictate where you swing and how you swing, it's going to be bad results.
With the way that Brock Pearson is hitting at the plate, the Bluefish would like to get someone on base as Redmond takes a fastball on the outside corner, 0-1. Maybe the best way is to test the infield with bunts. The 0-1. Way outside, 1 ball, 1 strike. The opposite argument could be Prentice Redmond leads the league in extra base hits, or one of the league leaders in extra base hits. Rather have him stroke a double than have him at first base on a bunt. 1-1, floats low, 2 balls and a strike. His changeup is not going over the plate.
He has not been able to control it, and if it is, it's a high changeup. So if timing, second time, third time through the order, you might not miss that pitch.
The 2-1, a floater staying high.
The changeup stays
high. Just like you
right
said,
there.
3 balls and 1 strike. And the batters, they have 20-20 vision or better. They're able to identify the grip. Only pitch that he's really been able to get over is the fastball. Yet the Bluefish are chasing the 3-1. Upstairs again, ball 4. And that appeared to be another changeup.
And that's Prentice Redmond with another walk, 2 of them on the day.
If the Bluefish would lead the way with Prentice Redmond, as he's setting an example, Bridgeport's going to be in great shape. They'll be able to knock out Corey Thurman early because his pitch count will skyrocket. He's already walked 3 batters today.
That gives Redmond 40 walks on the season. Pretty good numbers. Gets on base more often than not. His on base percentage, .352.
This is not the only game taking place in the morning. Camden leads Lancaster 2-1 in the bottom of the third from Campbell's Field. The Bluefish hoping that Camden continues to fall. The pitch is smacked to deep left field. Shanks on the track of the wall. That ball bangs off the wall. Redmond hustling towards third. Peterson must stay at first. A long single for Brock. Runners at the corners with one man out for Luis Lopez.
That ball was hit hard. Brock Peterson said, "You are not sneaking one by me again."
And that wind probably held that ball in the park. It's fair to say that ball was scorched even more than the other one.
No question about it, but sometimes you hit a ball a lot squarer on the barrel and it turns into a line drive, what you want to hit. And that one just didn't quite get elevated enough because it seemed like it had the distance.
One man out, Luis Lopez walked. He was given the 3 pitches outside, and then Salvador Paniagua, or Salvador Manriquez, gave him the next one. The pitch is outside, 1 ball and no strikes. Keep on confusing. Paniagua with Manriquez. Solomon Manriquez, Salvador Paniagua. But Manriquez behind home plate. First 3 pitches went off the strike zone and decided for the 4th one should be outside as well. 1-0. Chased. 1 ball, 1 strike. Lopez fake spikes his helmet. He knew he should not have swung at the changeup. That changeup is outside the strike zone and every time.
He's missed consistently. Luis Lopez just getting a bit antsy. He hasn't seen a strike yet. He sees base runners on, and he wants to add to his RBI total and help the Bluefish get a win.
Except if he's over antsy, he's going to turn into a double play with that changeup. That changeup is not going in the zone. Only his fastball is, the 1-1. Swung on and lifted in the air to right field. Should be playable for Brandon Hovind, who makes the call and the catch. A bluff made, an unproductive out for Lopez as the catcher Manriquez comes from behind home plate to come up with the baseball. That's what happens when you get a bit antsy. Especially against Thurman. He reads body language very well and bat language very well. Two men out after the F9 set of Bernard Jones.
Jones missed an opportunity in the first inning, and now he's got another chance to make up for it.
In Little League, when there was a pitcher that could not throw too many strikes, first time around, we would usually cut and we'd usually be fooled. Second time around, you let those pitches go because you understood what he was throwing. Whether we were able to execute that plan or not is a different story. The two-out toss is chased. And another pitch 6 inches off the plate.
That's if little leaguers have that mental capability to assess what's going on other than just swinging at what's around the zone.
Sometimes athletes overthink. The 0-1 line drive to right field, but Hobman has a beat on it to make the catch. Professionals overthink, and sometimes little leaguers underthink. It's that delicate balance that makes the greats. And the Bluefish are out of the inning. They strand two more base runners at the end of three. Bridgeport trailing 2-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on the Bluefish Broadcast Network.
A poem entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice-cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Beer garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's going to be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, frost-brewed Coors Light.
Thank you. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this little ditty America's pastime. Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice. Some games are early, some are at night. But there's always a beer man with ice-cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name. So even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have Frost Brewed Refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week. So I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store. But stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Kennard Jones brought up a valid point a few days ago. Every time that a batter is communicating with the rest of his or her team, because it could be baseball or softball, but any time that a player is communicating with that person's team, usually they're indicating fastball is a little bit choppy, breaking ball is the best, or breaking ball is great, fastball is the best. The batters have to be communicating with each other about Thurman's changeup. It's staying outside the zone, and yet the Bluefish continue to fish for it. 2-0 to score in the top of the fourth inning. Raymar Diaz, the right-hander, delivers. The pitch is chopped on the ground to third. Snagged on one hop by Lopez. Squares and fires one away.
One pitch, one out. Good way to start the fourth for Raymar.
The communication that goes on between all of the players is succinct and accurate. They know what they're seeing out there. But the problem is the Bluefish have been unable to execute the plan that they have put forward, or at least Lopez, Rodriguez, and a few other veterans have tried to implement. First pitch is inside, one ball, no strikes. And Willie Upshaw is fully aware of the plan at the plate. He works with the mechanics. He's one of the best hitting coaches in Major League Baseball for a long time. And he's an expert in hitting. And the mechanics, the 1-0 is outside 2-0.
He is, and we've seen that James Simmons is a product. He has gotten steadily better over the course of the season, and that's courtesy of Willie Upshaw taking his time and really working on his swing.
The next toss is over the middle of the plate, two balls and one strike. It's not as if you're dealing with a guy who's throwing 88, 89 miles per hour like Raymar Diaz. That's the average pitcher in this league. There are some guys that throw 93, 94, 95. But the average about 88 to 90. The 2-1 is slapped foul to the left. Two balls, two strikes. So it's nothing unusual. The anomaly is Corey Thurman. But everyone knows what Corey Thurman's capable of. Everybody does.
Similar to Halama, he doesn't throw very hard either.
2-2. Slap foul to the left. I'll argue this point. John Halama is a much easier pitcher to hit than Corey Thurman because Halama at least touches 85, 86 on occasion. He'll do that. And his curveball stays a little bit higher on a plane. The 2-2 is outside, three balls, two strikes. Difference is Halama's around the strike zone. Thurman's not. Luis Lopez talked about his experience in the Can-Am League, where the tendency is to not throw nearly as many strikes. They're all over the place. It was very difficult for him to perform there. 3-2 is fouled off the glove of Machete. Three balls, two strikes. He said flat out, it is a very difficult league to hit in because you don't know where the ball is going. They're not around the plate. It may be easier to hit AAA pitching than it is Can-Am, even though those players are around the plate. And they throw more strikes. That was his argument. 3-2 is looking foul to the left.
A tough at bat here by Fiorentino. He's now reached. He had a single. He scored a run in the second. 10 straight games with a hit. 13 out of 14 since being signed.
As a baseball player, if you knew that a pitcher was going to be around the plate, would your eyes jump out when you saw those pitches?
No question about it. There's some pitchers that you know and are labeled as strike throwers. Get ahead, stay ahead, try to make early contact or produce early contact. And you get excited to face those type of pitchers. Yes, they can put you out with their best stuff, but you're ready to smack it.
3-2. Waved after strike three. Down goes Fiorentino. He's now 1-for-2, the second strikeout of the game for Diaz, as it says of Chris Nowak.
Rodriguez had that quick mound meeting with Diaz, wanted to get on the same page after he'd thrown him a heavy dose of fastballs that were fouled off back. He came a little off-speed stuff and threw it for a strike.
Intelligence has much to do with pitching as it does with physical ability. The two-out toss is waved at by Nowak, way out in front, 0-1. But it is exasperating to see a guy that throws softer fastballs, maybe not with as much movement or whatever, softer fastballs than a high school pitcher does. The 0-1 is outside, one ball, one strike.
But the difference with a high school pitcher and a pitcher like Corey Thurman is high school pitchers are pretty sporadic. You really don't know where that ball is going to go. Thurman, he's well aware of his control.
1-1. Low and in the dirt. Two balls, one strike. The only pitchers in high school that really know where their pitches are going are the ones that have the draft status as high as they are, and they're expected to run right through the minor league ranks quickly as the next pitch is pulled foul to the left. Two balls and two strikes. Perfect example of that is Jeff Niemann of the Tampa Bay Rays. Look at his stuff. Pure filter. Even a guy like David Price took a few years, even once he was coming from Vanderbilt. 2-2. Upstairs, 3-2.
Doesn't happen overnight. Baseball is a system. You kind of get bred up and figured out where and when your time is. And Nowak is trying to get his timing on Diaz. Got to be careful with this pitch.
3-2. Check swing. Did he go? No, says the first base umpire, Ronnie Whiting. Two men out. A walk to Nowak. That may have been an intelligent move.
First walk issued by Raymar Diaz. And like I said, he had to be careful.
That was probably a wise choice. Even though James Shanks is a very good power hitter, Nowak has been obliterating Bluefish pitching. A two-out pitch to Shanks, lifted down the left field line, but foul. No balls and one strike.
And it's not as no walk has had a vast amount of hits, just 2 for 8 in the series coming into today. But those two hits were home runs with 5 RBIs. So it's been the big bat that's done them in.
Hey, Willie Upshaw released Elliot Ayala for the simple reason of he did not want a guy just hitting singles on his ball club, as the 0-1 is looking foul to the right, no balls and 2 strikes, when he had a bum shoulder and could not play any defense. He wanted a DH that could produce power.
And that's the truth, and you have other players in the lineup that are there for that reason, to get on base, to do this, do that, and Ayala was taking a spot where somebody could be driving runs in.
The 0-2 is a high fly ball to left center field. That should stay in the park with the wind driving in. Simmons makes the catch for the final out of the frame. The center fielder records the out. The Bluefish gave up a 2-out walk, but the runner stays on base. At the end of 3.5, Bridgeport down 2-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing, a smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with. Sorry, Alan. Drumsticks. Chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant. A motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. A spark plug. A domino. A house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Bluefish Baseball is back on the air. Perry Miles with RJ Garcia, the Bluefish, and the York Revolution from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. As Luis Rodriguez moves up to the plate, he's followed by James Simmons and Brett Dowdy, as the Bluefish fans give the unofficial Soldier Boy his cheer down the left side.
The Bat Boy doing a nice little routine that he does every so often, depending on what the MC DJ Blair puts on.
The first pitch on its way from Corey Thurman is a line drive strike to left. James Shanks makes the play. One away. He drifted towards left center field, jutted forward a little bit to make the catch. And with one man out, James Simmons moves forward.
That ball was hit on the screws. Luis Rodriguez has been swinging a great bat of recent, since July has hit and the Bluefish have been playing better. He's been a key contributor.
James Simmons, a pop fly foul out to third base. As Thurman lifts his glove and delivers. First pitch on the outside corner, 0-1.
Bluefish have left runners on each of the first 3 innings. 6 total now, Perry.
Never a good sign. The 0-1. A high fly to deep left center field. Sprinting back towards the alley to make the catch is Scott Grimes for out number 2. A normal BP fastball would provide so much power that Grimes would not be able to get there. The wall of wind knocked it down too.
Probably why Grimes is playing so shallow. I haven't seen a center player, center fielder, play as close to the infield, I think, yet this season in Bridgeport. He had to track back, and that was a routine fly ball.
How far can a knuckleballer be hit? The pitch is on the outside corner, 0-1, especially to center. Scott Grimes has that much confidence in Thurman that he'll keep the ball within 390 feet in center. The 0-1, a fister towards short. Charging to his left, squaring and firing to first in plenty of time was Joe Thurston for the final out of the inning. Brett Doughty 0-2 today. End of four after the 1-2-3. The Bluefish down 2-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com. We'll be right back after these words from our local sponsors.
Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team, including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week. Stop in and meet our team or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the major league experience.
The Gear Shop at the Ballpark at Harbor Yard is your one-stop shop for everything Bluefish. Take a break from the action and check out all your Bluefish souvenir favorites. From men's and women's t-shirts and a wide selection of home, road, and other trendy hats, to Fear the Fin rally towels, team photos, and commemorative baseballs. The Gear Shop has it all. Don't forget about our kids' wear section, game-worn jerseys, even your own stuffed BB the Bluefish, and more. The Bluefish Gear Shop is located on the third base side of the concourse level at the ballpark at Harbor Yard and is open on game days. Come and browse all your favorite Bluefish apparel from an hour before the first pitch until the final out is made. Can't make it to the ballpark on game day but still want to support Fairfield County's only professional baseball team? Then check out the new Bluefish online store at BridgeportBluefish.com or call 203-345-4800 to schedule an appointment. The Bluefish Gear Shop. Perfect gifts for all ages and all sizes. Located at the ballpark at Harbor Yard, 500 Main Street, Bridgeport, Connecticut.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Harry Miles here with RJ Garcia, and we will direct our attention to RJ for the play-by-play call. I'll act as the color commentator for 5, 6, and 7. RJ, take it away.
Well, thanks, Barry. Very nice of you to add a little color to your stature there. First pitch from Diaz, low for a ball to Solomon Manriquez. The 8-9-1 due up Scott Grimes behind him, then Brandon Hovman to follow.
Diaz has been solid today, but he's been outperformed by Corey Thurman and his ability to induce some grounders.
Way inside on the second offering, 2-0 now to Manriquez. Fifth inning of action, two runs to none. The Revolution leading the Bluefish, three hits apiece. Been a relatively even played game.
Just a couple of hits in that second inning resulted in a couple of fielder's choices and run scoring.
Next pitch, the 2-0 is hit to right field. Joey Gathright gets underneath it and makes the play.
The ball is carrying with much more ease to right field than it is anywhere else. That wind is whipping out, clear sky, perfect conditions for a ball game, although tomorrow could get a little bit nasty.
It has rain in the forecast. They'll have to deal as the time moves on, but we got today to worry about. And Gathright, you've seen a little bit shaky, hadn't played right field since 2004. He took a couple stutter steps back, but he does make the play for the first out, and here is Scott Grimes. Diaz, first pitch, slider in there for a strike.
What most people know about right field is that usually the strongest arm is located in right field. If you look at the big leaguers, Vladimir Guerrero and Ichiro Suzuki, they have the strongest arms. But what people don't realize is during the afternoon hours, it can be difficult to see.
The 0-1 floats across for a strike. He's got Grimes down 0-2.
The sunshine is beating on the field, and with the way that the ballpark at Harbor Yard is constructed, Kennard Jones is looking southwest, which is where the sunshine is.
The 0-2 in the dirt, 1-2.
Sun comes up and down from the southern hemisphere to the northern hemisphere. It's still at about 23 degrees. Up in Bridgeport, about the 40-degree mark in latitude.
Either way, you're playing a day game, much different conditions than the normal night affairs. 1-2, swung on, hit down the right field line, foul. This one's going towards the seats, and we'll get there with Gathright giving chase.
So Joey Gathright, like many right fielders before him, might have to wear that eye black or sunglasses in order to have his eyes not be blinded by the sunshine. Line drives, believe it or not, are the most difficult thing to field except in sunshiny conditions.
Crowd getting into it for this 1-2 pitch from Raymar. Swung on, number down the third baseline. Luis Lopez charging barehand on the run. Not in time. Scott Grimes beats it out.
Infield single for Grimes. Nice try from Lopez. But Grimes is one of the fastest players on the team. And perhaps Grimes will get going with infield singles and
right fielder number six,
other maneuvers that he uses. If players are struggling with the power, they might as well bunt to get on. Especially if you have the kind of speed Grimes possesses on a day-to-day basis.
And a lot of it is rhythm for hitters. And if you can get something positive going and get on the base path anyway, you can try to get it going. And Scott Grimes, after striking out in his first at-bat, gets it with an infield single. Here's Brandon Hovman, the leadoff batter. He squares, shows bunt, pulls back for a ball.
11 for 11 this year, stolen base chances for Grimes, who had to miss a period of time this year due to a broken hand.
So there's a lot of factors that have played into Grimes' subpar season thus far. The 1-0 hits the outside part of the plate for a strike. Diaz now 1-1 on Brandon Hovman, who has a single, 1-for-2, but was caught stealing in the third inning.
With Hovman's ability to make contact, does York at any point go for a hit and run, considering Grimes is a stolen base threat? Diaz has not been all too quick at the mound, going to home plate with his back turned at first from the right side.
Next pitch squares again. Rodriguez bluffs down to first. That ball was a strike.
It was on the outside corner.
Mills indicated, and Hovman seems a little bit perplexed, but he'll step back in and reconsider the next pitch.
The one thing batters must understand, David Mills has been giving the outside corner strikes and the inside corner balls. More leeway towards the outside than the inside. Every game.
For righties and lefties, either side. The 1-2 swung on off the glove. Doughty knocks it down, but the ball scatters behind second base. Strange occurrence, but that's going to be a single for Brandon Hovman.
You talk about pinball and all those bonus scores. Well, that might as well have been a bonus score for York. They were able to hit the targets on the left and right side and finally shot up for the jackpot.
That was a strange play. It was hit so hard that Diaz couldn't quite get his glove out further enough to web it.
The way that I would compare it, you ever see the Men in Black series, the movies?
Yep.
It's the way that one of those magnetic pinballs, if you will, which is supposed to provide all sources of energy for Earth, the way that it flies around and damages all the objects around it, the same way it damaged Diaz's glove, took care of Doughty too.
Next pitch in the dirt. Good block by Machete.
You know what I'm referring to.
Yeah, I guess. I guess you can compare that to the Men in Black series, the little ball. Sure, that's fine. But the one thing for Diaz is he still has his glove intact, and Doughty still maybe has a bruise, but his chest is still there as well.
I'm sure it is.
1-0 to Joe Thurston. He's 0-2 today. pitch low and inside for a ball. Freaky circumstances. Grimes reached on that infield single. That one by Hovman. Similar to when they scored in the second inning. Strange occurrence. We'll see if Diaz can rebound here. The fifth inning has been a problem for the Bluefish all season. The 2-0, that one gets on the outside part for a strike.
It's been when Raymar Diaz has fallen behind in counts, just like any other pitcher in this league, that they fall into bad habits or provide below average tosses.
2-1, one out. Diaz bluffs and checks Grimes at second. How about the fifth inning, Perry? Opponents have been doubling up the Bluefish in total runs scored, 67 to 33.
The one thing that those stats do not denote.
2-1 outside, 3-1.
If you compare what guys like Isaac Hess, Raymar Diaz earlier in the season, and a few other pitchers that were on the ball club, including Toby Stoner, even Joe Bateman when he was pitching in the fifth inning, you look at their stats, second, third time around, it was brutal. And the numbers have improved exponentially.
3-1 way outside and a walk by Thurston. He's on base for the first time today, and now they're chock full of revs.
I never realized you were into Folger's coffee. Chock full?
Chock full?
Yeah.
All right, I don't know. I didn't compare it to the Folgers, but either way, we are here, and it was a morning game, so we needed some coffee to get going.
I'm more of an orange juice guy. Are you a coffee guy?
Recently, probably about a year or so into the coffee game, and I didn't like the taste, but a couple sips when I was on spring break in my final year of college, and I told my friend I couldn't believe this is what I was missing out on.
What was it, Starbucks? Folger? Was it just regular?
I don't know. I was at a diner, and they happened to bring an extra cup of coffee, and she poured it, and I looked at it cross-eyed, and my friends basically said, just drink it. And I did, and I don't think I've not started a day without coffee since.
My caffeine, Just like Raymar Diaz, is broadcasting games. His is on the map. It's always about performance, right?
Yep.
My caffeine is broadcasting games, but I have a thing for sweets. I have to limit those.
See, you get your sugar.
Paul Herman, the PR director, did me in today by bringing in the Dunkin' Donuts donuts. They were so good.
I'm glad you're with us. And we're back, too, after that short mound meeting. Diaz faces Ramon Castro. First pitch, swing and foul back. Big, big spot, Ramon Castro. He's 0-for-2 today. And this is the third time through the order that you mentioned, Perry. We'll see if Diaz can escape some trouble. Castro, not the quickest guy. And when he rolls one over, he doesn't necessarily hustle out of the box.
The 0-1.
Swung on and missed. 0-2. It's all right, Perry. We'll let that one slide.
I'm so accustomed to calling the fifth inning on the road that suddenly carried it over. But Raymar Diaz, when he's most effective, he induces those ground balls. He induces plenty of double plays. When he's ineffective,
the ball's up in the zone. As you mentioned, fly balls, home runs, the whole nine. The 0-2 to Castro in the dirt. Good block by Machete.
Early in the season, he was getting ahead of plenty of hitters, but was unable to finish them off, and it led to a plethora of problems.
Of late, he's been finishing opponents off, batters in the box, and he's got Castro 1-2. Either way, he'd love an out. He can do it himself or get a ground ball, and that's what the infield's playing, double play depth. That one's on the outside part of the plate. Strike three, Raymar Diaz gets Castro looking.
That was a beautifully executed pitch. Diaz understanding Mills' strike zone. Castro, irate as he took off his helmet and started screaming at himself.
I don't know if that was at himself or the fact that the zone was a little wide a lot of factors, but nobody wants to go down looking with the bases loaded.
Raymar Diaz was pitching to the outside.
First pitch breaks across the inside part to Perez for a strike.
And Castro has a close stance with his foot very close to the chalk in the batter's box. He'd be able to identify an outside corner strike, not necessarily as much to the inside corner.
Perez awaits the 0-1. Same spot. Diaz finds the breaking ball on the inside part of the plate. Strike number two. Base is still full of them. Make or break for the Bluefish here in the fifth. Only down 2-0. Plenty of baseball left. Have to limit the damage here. Diaz set, waiting for Luis Rodriguez's sign. The 0-2, two outs. Pitch on the way, swung on and missed. Perez down on strikes. Back-to-back strikeouts for Raymar Diaz, who escapes a fifth-inning bases-loaded jam for the Bluefish. We're through 4.5. 2-0 still. York leads the Bluefish. We'll be back after a word from our sponsors.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how far, how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I use to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community, by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
We welcome you back, Bluefish Broadcast Network. RJ Garcia, Perry Miles. We're in the bottom half of the fifth inning. 2-0 York Revolution lead. Top of the lineup for the Bluefish, Joey Gathright, Eddie Rogers, Prentice Redmond. Corey Thurman back to work after a six-pitch fourth inning, where he set Luis Rodriguez, James Simmons, Brett Doughty down in order. But this is the third time through the order, and as we mentioned, Perry, this could be where the batters start to get a better idea of what Thurman is all about.
These veteran guys have had plenty of experience with what Thurman is all about.
First pitch strike on the inside.
They should know what he's all about to be able to establish the changeup low.
Working quick, Thurman right back at it. Next pitch, swung on and missed. Strike number two.
Every changeup that he's thrown in the zone has been high.
That was a changeup down a bit, and Gathright swung right over the top. Now he's got himself in a hole, 0-2. Pitch on its way, slap back. Still 0-2.
It's not as if Thurman is overpowering. It's not even 95, 98 heat. All you really need to do if you're a Bluefish player is just continue to foul back the way that Joey Gathright has done in his past. Fight the ball off.
0-2. swung on in the dirt. Gathright disgusted with himself as he heads back to the dugout, down on strikes.
It almost feels that the Bluefish feel so comfortable at the plate that their focus is not the same against Thurman as it would be against every other run-of-the-mill pitcher.
It's almost as if they're anticipating that batting practice speed, as you had mentioned, rather than locking in and be like, okay, I gotta hit this guy. Now it's Eddie Rogers. He had a single, couple stolen bases in the first. He swings at the first pitch, skies it to the shortstop. Tracking it over is Joe Thurston. He makes the play. Two down now in the fifth.
Last inning was a four-pitch inning for Thurman, and he is almost matching that. Actually, a six-pitch inning, and he's almost matching that. It was crazy. And now he's almost on track for that.
Four pitches to Gathright, one to Rogers. He's got two outs on five pitches here. We got Prentice Redmond due up. He's been on base twice. Does not have a registered at bat. Couple of walks. First pitch from Thurman, inside and tight for a ball.
The Bluefish have not scored since two outs in the first inning of yesterday's game.
Next pitch, Prentice Redmond takes a strike.
That spans 13 full frames. 4 2/3 today and 8 2/3 right in the third yesterday.
Next pitch, good breaking ball by Thurman. That one's on the inside for a strike. 1-2 now, two outs. Bottom of the fifth, Brock Peterson waits on deck. Would love to not have him lead off, give him an at-bat with a runner on. Prentice Redmond looking to get on base. 1-2 from Thurman. Swung on and missed, and Thurman strikes out two batters in the fifth inning, and the Bluefish go down easy. No hits, no runners left on. We're through five, and we'll be back at the ballpark at Harbor Yard after this.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, pork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms? The pace of the game? The mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
Well, welcome back. Bluefish Broadcast Network here on Bluefish.com, BridgeportBluefish.com. We're in the sixth inning. RJ Garcia, Perry Miles. Ray Mardia is back to work. He's going to have to deal with the 5-6-7. Jeff Fiorentino, Chris Nowak, James Shanks. Fiorentino to lead it off. He's got a single and a run scored in the second. Hit streak now to 10 straight, 13 of 14 since joining the Revolution. And Diaz set on the first pitch to him. That fastball is over for a strike.
Jeff Fiorentino has plenty of big league experience, four separate years on his resume, and he's done a tremendous job with York in the early going.
Next pitch, just low, 1-1. Diaz has been pitching very good. He's got at least six innings in his last two starts. 1-1, six earned runs over that span. Next pitch, swung on, foul ball down the line. Luis Lopez giving chase and just in front of the tarp, could not gather it. Good effort by the third baseman, Lopez.
He made a break for as well as he possibly could have, but just came up short of the baseball. Raymar Diaz has been able to escape some jams today that early in the season he may not have been able to wiggle out of. It is a testament to how much Willie Upshaw has worked with Diaz, Terry McGriff, and also give credit to himself.
Next pitch, just low, 2-2.
Many players give credit to the coaches and give credit to the manager. The player has to make the adjustment and execute that adjustment.
No question about it, Perry. And if you don't want to succeed, then you won't succeed. 2-2. Swung on, chopper to Eddie Rogers. Charging. Good play on a short hop. Gets the speedy Fiorentino for the first out of the sixth.
We've seen a couple of times this year where Rogers has sprinted forward, tried that short hop scoop, and the ball dies on the grass or the ball flips well above his head. That time, it was perfect read from the shortstop. That was the only play he could have made.
And we mentioned it earlier when Brandon Hovman got thrown out, caught stealing, the hesitation. Sometimes Eddie Rogers gets caught hesitating on whether to charge or whether to stay back on those high choppers to short. That one, no question. First pitch to Nowak, slider across for a strike.
Nowak has reached base twice because the Bluefish really do not want to mess with him at this point. He's already hit a double and drawn a walk.
That pitch inside and high for a ball, 1-1.
Nobody wants to mess with Nowak, just like nobody wants to mess with a Zohan.
Or Brock Peterson, one of the two.
True. All three of them have specialized skills.
Nowak with his 15 home runs. He's tied for second for the league lead, so he's right up there. Diaz delivers low for a ball. 2-1 on Nowak on this beautiful Wednesday afternoon in Bridgeport, Connecticut. Nice and breezy by the Long Island Sound where the stadium is located, ballpark at Harbor Yard. 2-1, swung on, line drive down a left field line. Kennard Jones giving chase. That one's going to one hop the wall. Plays it on a bounce, and the throw is going to come into second. And Nowak's in, standing up on a broken bat double.
That ball, had there been less wind today, would have gone out of the park. That's how strong Nowak is. He pulled it almost directly down the line. And that's why many scouts are looking at him. His numbers would certainly project at the next level of play, whether it be AAA or the big leagues.
That's 36 extra base hits now on the season for Nowak, who has two doubles today. Perfect thus far against Raymar Diaz. And now another jam, runner on in scoring position for James Shanks. Diaz deals, high bouncer to Rogers, knocks it down, double clutches, makes a play at first. What a excellent defensive play by shortstop Eddie Rogers.
He knocked it down, and when you knock it down, it's rare that he has an opportunity to throw anybody out. Shanks does not exhibit the same kind of speed rolling down the first base side. Either way, a tremendous play as he rotated behind the second base bag.
That was unreal. How lucky do you get? Because when you knock it down, there's no telling where that ball is going to go. You just want to try to keep it in front of you. Kind of bounce right back up to him in the glove, and he was able to corral it and get a hand on it and make the play. And for Shanks, you can't blame him. He might have thought that was a single. Wasn't necessarily hustling out of the box. First pitch, Solomon Manriquez takes for a strike.
Diaz has been pitching very well today, but this is a mark where he needs to stand tall. His team's down 2-0. Six innings, three runs may look good.
Manriquez sees another slider. This one's a jam shot to Doughty at second. Takes care of him.
But that looks better. Six innings, two-run baseball, and he held the fort down for what he needed to.
He did. He avoided that part of the order. Nowak gets on with the double, but that's going to be it. A base runner's left on for York. Bridgeport comes to bat in their half of the sixth inning when we get back.
kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to BridgeportBluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
Looking for something to do that the whole family will enjoy? Then drop on by the box office, the ballpark at Harbor Yard, to pick up your individual.
At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Welcome back. You're in tune with the Bridgeport Bluefish Broadcast Network. RJ Garcia, Perry Miles, back at it, sixth inning for the Fish. Brock Peterson, Luis Lopez, Kennard Jones due up. 2-0 York Revolution, the visitors taking care of the Bluefish thus far. Back-to-back matinee games, 11 o'clock camp days. Good for the Rebs to get out early after this one, get back at a decent time.
Brock Peterson has been smacking Thurman today. One fly ball out and one line drive single off the wall.
That one gets well away from Thurman. Maybe lost a grip there. Says, my bad, and that's going to be a ball.
Perhaps he was trying to back Peterson off the plate, even though he did indicate it as a surface thing. Deep down, he knows how hard Peterson rocked the ball the last few times.
Yeah, not sure if he's trying to hit him there, though. The 1-0 bounces in the dirt outside, 2-0.
Well, he's not trying to hit him. He's trying to make him uncomfortable up there.
Clearly, it looks as Thurman's uncomfortable with Brock Peterson and the batter's box. That might be more of it.
Hey, if you were a pitcher, would you be?
That's why I'm not out there, Perry. That's why I'm right here in the booth. 2-0, Thurman to Peterson. Pitch on the way. That one swung on opposite field. That one's got right center gap, and it's carrying. Getting deep. It's got a chance off the wall. Peterson hustling, and he'll trot into second with a stand-up double.
First, a long shot off the wall and left. That's a single. Next shot off the wall and right center field. That ball kept on carrying. Not as much as before. Wind has died down a bit. But Brock Peterson missed his 20th home run of the season by a foot in height.
Just about, and where he hit it, that wall seems to be elevated about 8 inches higher than the yellow mark around the rest of the outfield wall. He places that just a little bit left. That one might have skipped over the top. For Brock Peterson, that's his 19th double of the year, matching his 19 home runs. Heck of a season so far, and now Luis Lopez is up. First pitch swinging, opposite field slap. Hovman makes the play on the line drive. Peterson got caught up, couldn't tag.
Peterson went halfway and then had to retreat to the bag. That may have been a mistake on his part, but he thought it was slicing towards the chalk. Had that done so, Peterson's easily scoring.
Peterson knows that that ball was hit well. He couldn't afford to sit on second base if he wanted to score a run there. He had to get a little cheat, a little jump start halfway there. It happened to be hit so hard that it stayed up long enough to get caught. So here's Kennard Jones. He's 0-for-2. A couple well-hit balls, but well-placed defense as he takes a first pitch strike.
And what you're noticing is Thurman, the third time around, has opted to go with fastball against Lopez. It was a fastball to the outside that Peterson smacked to the opposite way. His fastball, clearly not as authoritative as what it once was.
The 0-1, Kennard Jones rolls one over to the second baseman, played on a hop. Andres Perez takes care of Kennard Jones, but moves over Brock Peterson to third. Luis Rodriguez now. So many Luis on this team. Luckily, Figueroa is on the bench today. I get even more confused, Barry.
You would have had to figure out all three names.
Tough when they sandwich players in between and keep them relatively close in the order.
Well, the way that many people would figure it out, Luis Figueroa is the shortest of the three. That's one part that you can take into account.
Thurman paints the outside corner on that slow changeup. 0-1 to Rodriguez.
And the way that you determine Luis Rodriguez from Luis Lopez, Luis Rodriguez a little bit darker skin than Lopez is.
Next pitch, swung on, foul down the line. 0-2 to Rodriguez. Not to mention they all play different positions, so.
Well, that could be it, but in the batting order, right?
True. Big spot for Luis Rodriguez. 0-2. Peterson on third base. He led off the inning with a double. He's been the first base runner since the third. Next pitch outside for a ball. 1-2. James Simmons waits on deck. The way he's been swinging the bat, if Luis Rodriguez could somehow get on base, knock in Brock Peterson, Simmons could prove to do some damage if he gets a chance. 1-2 in the dirt, good block by Manriquez.
Rodriguez has been able to identify the changeup right off the bat and where it's located, which is a good sign for him, but it's not been a good sign for most of the hitters. Just 4 hits today for the Fish.
And that's it. And Peterson has 2 of them. The other coming from Rodriguez. See if he matches his multi-hit game. The 2-2 just off the plate. 3-2 now to Luis Rodriguez.
Slider outside. There is some action brewing down the left field line for York. Kick stretching from one of the relief pitchers. He's still not turning around. You've had his number?
Might be Nova, judging by his tall, lengthy demeanor. 3-2, 2 outs, bottom of the 6th. Brock Peterson in at third, swung on, high fly ball out of play.
That ball was up at Rodriguez's eyes. Made him glare at the baseball even more.
We're going to do it again. Full count to Rodriguez. Simmons waits on deck. Brock Peterson at third. Big spot for the Fish. The changeup gets Luis Rodriguez down on strikes. And Corey Thurman powers his way through 6 innings. And we do too, and we're through that. We're coming back with the top half of the 7th inning. When we get back, you're listening to Bridgeport Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Best or follow up with your supervisor, because Miller Time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers, who'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk and never talk.
Nice.
During your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork,
fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
Welcome back. Bridgeport Bluefish baseball, top half of the seventh inning. Raymar Diaz back in work. He's dealing with 9-1-2. Scott Grimes, Brandon Hobman, Joe Thurston for the Revs. The only runs coming back in the second inning. 2-0 is where we stand. First pitch low to Grimes. Grimes struck out in his first at-bat. Second inning ended at that. Had a single in his last at-bat in the fifth, and here he is in the seventh looking for another. A little bit of action in the Bluefish bullpen. Next pitch upstairs for a ball, 2-0.
Might be Julio De Paula.
Diaz working very well today, limiting the damage, escaping some jams. 2-0. Grimes taking all the way. Diaz throws a strike.
Diaz's pitch count is certainly getting up there. York Revolution tends to do that to individuals. They work the counts very deep, and he's over 100 pitches on the day.
The 2-1 from Diaz, that gets the outside part of the plate, 2-2.
If the Bluefish right-hander is able to continue to provide success, he may not come out in this inning, but in all likelihood, the seventh inning is going to be his final one. There is a left-hander who appears to be Jesse English down the right field line.
The 2-2 swung on line drive. Base hit between Rogers and Lopez on the left side. Grimes has two hits in his last two at-bats. That's going to bring up the top half of the order. Brandon Hobman to the dish. Slap single in his last at-bat. He's 2-for-3.
Not too much baseball action this afternoon, although the River Sharks are clinging to a one-run lead against the Barnstormers. 2-1 in the top of the eighth from Campbell's Field. And we will quickly get to an update of any local scores from baseball in a moment.
Diaz set. Grimes over at first. Hobman shows bunt, lays it down. Good job fielding his position. And a nice throw to get the lead runner, Grimes, at second.
Sacrifice was unsuccessful.
Fielder's choice. 1-6 gets the job done for the first out.
The Mets trail the Nationals 2-1 in the top of the fourth with a runner at second. The Yankees play at 3:40 this afternoon. Boston and Texas at 8:05. There are two other games taking place. The now depleted Miami Marlins are scoreless with the Atlanta Braves. The now revamped Pittsburgh Pirates tied at 1 against the Cubs in the bottom of the second. Those are the scores.
Hobman switches places with Scott Grimes at first. One out here. Joe Thurston takes low for a ball. The camp kids are getting into it. Let's go Bluefish chant. No, this is a big inning for them. Seventh, it's time to lock and load if you're the fish, and getting out of here unscathed is a good start. Checking at Hobman. Good throw over by Diaz. Just a little late. 2-1 guys warming up, as Perry mentioned. A lefty and a righty. Diaz still on the mound. Next pitch for a strike. He has done an excellent job controlling his pitches today. 1-1 in the seventh inning. Beautiful blue sky this afternoon. Not really a cloud visible. Thurston waits. Diaz with the long stare down. That's on the outside part for a strike. And both pitchers seem to have found David Mills' strike zone.
That would be a fair statement to make. Raymar Diaz appreciates it. The one thing that he doesn't appreciate is the fact that his team is down 2-0. He'd like the bats to come alive.
The 1-2, that one's a jam shot going the other way is Thurston. Two runners on now.
And it's a similar situation that the Bluefish right-hander faced earlier in the contest in that fifth inning. The difference was that there were the bases loaded with one man out instead of runners at first and second, with Ramon Castro stepping up to the dish. Willie Upshaw coming out.
This might do it for him. Indication, and there it is. Down to the bullpen. Willie Upshaw has seen enough, and it's a tough break because that was a good pitch that Raymar Diaz made on that last batter, and he hands the ball over, and it's going to be the righty. Going to the bullpen are the Bluefish, and this call to the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. We'll let you know who Upshaw calls upon when we get back after this.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Sharktooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle-nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top Can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
And welcome back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. This call to the bullpen is Julio DePaula, presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Couple more warm-up tosses and he'll be ready to go. See if he can do as Diaz did all day, and that's get out of jams.
This year, Julio DePaula, 3.52 ERA, one win, 7 2/3, giving up 4 runs, 3 of them earned. Opponents are hitting well against him. This year it's been home run or extra base hit or nothing. 2 home runs in the early going allowed.
5 doubles on his 25, or excuse me, messing that up there, sorry about that. 2 doubles on 10 hits, 2 home runs, 2 doubles. Not a good ratio. And he's got Castro, one of the better extra base RBI guys in the league to deal with. One out, Thurston at first, and Castro takes a first pitch strike from DePaula.
Tongue twisters, eh?
I try to fill it all in. Sometimes you get caught up, but either way, here we are getting it done in the seventh inning as DePaula hopes to do the same with speed on at the base paths. Have to take care of Castro. Next pitch outside part of the plate for a strike.
Castro looking back. wondering what's going on. I don't believe he agreed with that call.
Well, he went down looking in the fifth inning with the bases chock full of them right there for you, Perry. And he was pretty unhappy with that call. And it was a similar strike that was called on that second one. And now he's found himself down 0-2. Checking on Hovman. Delivers way outside. Great grab by Machete.
Julio DePaul throws about 92 miles per hour with the fastball. And he's capable of delivering beams every time. But that one was a purpose pitch to look further outside. So maybe he goes inside with some soft stuff.
Rodriguez gives the sign, sets up outside. Castro flips the bat at it, but that's going to be a fly ball. James Simmons tracking it down. The center fielder takes care of it. Tagging and moving to third is Brandon Hovman. Two outs now in the seventh inning. And that's going to spring one of the league leaders in average, Andres Perez.
He's had his struggles today, going 0-3. But Perez is due.
At 329 on the season, no question about it. Perez ranking second behind Godwin at a 355 mark. That's remarkable. 104 hits in 70 games for Godwin. Perez, 101 hits, 79 games. The difference, Perez, an RBI home run guy, 46 of those and 11 jacks on the year. Perez just looking for some insurance here, not necessarily a home run with two outs. Base knock will be just as effective here. Thurston at first, takes the lead. First pitch swinging is Perez, rolls one over to Doughty. Handles it easy. DuPala comes in. Gets out of the jam. Couple runners left on base for York, and we're through six and a half innings. Still 2-0 Revs lead the Bluefish.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No, the coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new two-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know, super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frostbrewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for.
The Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I use to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
We welcome you back in to the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Just past 1 o'clock, 1:15 on the East Coast. We're in the bottom of the seventh inning. The York Revolution, defending Atlantic League champions, looking to win the series here in Bridgeport. They're almost there. They're up 2-0. Thanks to Corey Thurman doing an excellent job against this Bluefish lineup. He's going to have to deal with 8-9-1. James Simmons, Brett Doughty, Joey Gathright here in the seventh. Could have been a lot worse for the Bluefish. Raymar Diaz got two runners on. Had to go to the bullpen. Julio DePaula gets the job done. Next two batters retired on a fly ball and a ground out. And we're still knotted at 2-0. Not knotted, but remains the same. James Simmons here. He is 0-2 thus far. 32 at-bats as a leadoff in the inning. 344 mark. Done a pretty good job in that situation. When you look at the numbers, one of the better on the team. First pitch from Thurman. Outside part. David Mills consistent all afternoon. That's a strike.
It's the way it's been. Outside corner strikes. Inside corner seems to be a little bit further with the ball.
The 0-1 way inside almost hits Simmons on the belt. 1-1, Dowdy's waiting on deck. Only his second game back since tearing his hamstring after only four games earlier in the year. 1-1, Simmons swings. Ground ball to Castro, double clutches. Get Simmons in plenty of time for the first out of the seventh.
There is a pitcher warming up down the left field line for the York Revolution, and it appears to be Stephen Penny, number 28.
This could be it for Thurman. Not to say he's pitching bad, because he is really handling the Bluefish well.
His pitch count is very low. Without looking, guess what his pitch count is.
Next pitch, Dowdy takes for a strike, including that one or without it. Well, either way, they're around the same, huh? I'm going to go 74 pitches.
That was pitch number 81.
He is being very efficient. Next pitch swung on, fouled off, right past Willie Upshaw down the third baseline.
The assumption would be that if Corey Thurman goes seven shutout innings and the Revolution cannot win the game, then he did not deserve to win the game.
As compared to Diaz, who was getting out of jams all day, he had 112 pitches in six and a third. The 0-2 to Dowdy skips in front of the plate. Good block by Solomon Manquez.
Eddie Rogers with a single, Brock Peterson with two hits, and Luis Rodriguez accounting for the only hits today.
This is where the Bluefish are going to have to make their mark. Three more times around to bat. Dowdy swings on, fouls one off down the right field line. This one could stay in play. Hobman giving chase, but that's going to bounce into the Kids Cove. Dowdy staying alive. Crowd still into it. Would like to see the Bluefish put some runs on the board, and that's going to start with getting on base. Thurman awaits for his right side of the infield to get back. Perez and Nowak, they both gave chase to that fly ball down the line. All set to go. And the 1-2. Swung on, good line drive, but that one's right at Thurston at short, and makes a strong throw and gets Dowdy. Two outs now in the seventh. A couple of ground balls, one to Castro, one to Thurston. And now the left-handed top of the order guy, Joey Gathright, in his first game back with the team after being released from the Louisville Bats, the Cincinnati Reds AAA affiliate.
Thurman is retired. 13 of the last 14 hitters have come to the plate. And that is an incredible mark. Gathright hoping to avoid that.
Another changeup. Thurman gets Gathright to swing over the top, and we've seen that very consistently for Joey Gathright in his first return. Thurman is heavy dosing the changeup. Apply when needed, and it's been needed very much thus far. The 0-1, that one Gathright stays on, but fouls back off to the left.
It is Thurman's ointments to his cuts.
Gathright now down 0-2. He's 0-3 today. He's got a couple of strikeouts, and he flew out to center field in the second. The 0-2, two outs. This time Gathright lays off the changeup for a ball.
The difference in this part of the game is that Thurman has gotten ahead of a few more hitters than he did earlier in the contest. His changeup is a little better. It's staying in the strike zone.
1-2. That fastball misses upstairs. 2-2.
And the Bluefish, because they avoided their game plan early when they had chances to score against Thurman, they find themselves on the negative side of a 2-0 score.
2-2, two outs in the bottom of the seventh. Gathright swings, chops one. Nowak, good jumping play, and beats Gathright, the speedster, to the bag for the third and final out. Nowak handled it all by himself. and the Bluefish are put away in the seventh, and we're through seven as well. Still 2-0. York is leading the Bluefish. Perry Miles will pick it up when we get back.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the Real Yellow Pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the Real Yellow Pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial Inc.
We thank R.J. Garcia for performing the play-by-play for 5, 6, and 7. It is the top of the eighth inning. The Bluefish have had a miserable time trying to come back when they've trailed after 7 innings of play. Most teams do. And they're just 4-39 when they're trailing after 7 innings heading into this contest as Julio DePaula fires a rifle low, 1-0, no strikes. First batter of the inning, Jeff Fiorentino. He's followed by Chris Nowak and James Shanks. No Jesse English to this point, although we may see him for the ninth inning. Next toss, fastball over the middle, 1-1.
DePaula, for his own right, he looked pretty all over the place early on in his first couple innings here with the Bluefish. Settled down so far.
The next toss by DePaula, fastball low, 1-1, becomes 2-1. Final line for Raymar Diaz, 6 1/3, 8 hits, 1 run. It was, or rather 2 runs, both of them were earned. 2 walks and 4 strikeouts, 112 pitches, 73 of those going for strikes. But he is on the losing side right now as opposed to the winning side. York having a 2-0 lead as Adam Thomas warms up in the bullpen for the Revolution.
Tough break for Raymar, back-to-back efforts where might get wasted. He went 7 innings, 3 earned against Lancaster.
Fastball is outside, 3-1.
And ended up taking the loss in 7 innings in a 2-3 game. Here we are, 2-0, and he goes 6 1/3, and another solid effort.
I will frame this statement in a different way. The 3-1 is outside, ball 4. The Bluefish was consistently negative throughout a long period of time. And there would be pieces of light that would seep right through. They're more inconsistent with their offensive performances now than they were before. Because they were consistently not producing runs before. And then the anomaly would be scoring 13, 15 runs. These days, they're scoring 8, 9 runs and then following it up with 1 run. Next toss is over the middle, 0-1. People talk about consistency. It's only consistent if the pattern develops.
It's true. They've been all over the place. The pitching has been more consistent.
The 0-1 slides inside, 1-1. Or did it not? No, it hit him. It was inside. It hit him.
It's a tough break. It looks like it hit the elbow pad protection of Nowak's left elbow, the one out in front, in case a pitch like that does get it. But it just nipped it and popped it off. It didn't hit it clean on.
James Shanks moves to the plate, and it is possible that he may bunt regardless of his power. Runners at first and second with a 2-0 lead. He squares to bunt and pops it up foul to the backstop, 0-1. Brock Peterson was not moving forward at all. Try to cover the bunt. James Shanks is not your prototypical bunter. Usually you reserve that role for a guy like Scott Grimes or maybe a Joe Thurston who's hitting second, or Brandon Hoffman who's hitting first. Infielders creep off as Shanks chases a slider away, 0-2.
Now Shanks is deep in the hole. Going to reconsider these signs from Noel Polanco, third base coach. One of the nicest guys on that York team, on the staff, Polanco. Always has a smile on his face.
Always has a joke, too. Always. And he's a former member of the Bluefish. Now just a player coach and more a coach than anything else. Lou Rodriguez serves the player coach role. The 0-2 is fouled off to the right. Off-balance hack from Shanks. Shanks reached in his first at-bat, fielder's choice in an RBI, and out recorded in the fourth, 6-3 in the sixth. He's 0-3. The 0-2, foul for the backstop.
Last time York was here, Polanco had his son out there shagging fly balls before the game. And let me tell you, he's got himself a nice little player on his hands.
How old would you say that his child is?
He said he was 12. And the way he was tracking down those balls and throwing them in, lefty too. I said, you really can't, I told Polanco after the game, I said, you really can't beat traveling around different stadium with his dad and learning baseball from the guys that play it every single day.
I'm sure he goes to school in May and June, I would assume that.
Right.
So this is his summertime vacation as the pitch is swung on and missed. For a strikeout, Shanks goes down. Sends up Solomon Manriquez.
This is the bottom half of the lineup. Willie Upshaw wants to have a few words with DuPaula.
Part of it is strategy with DuPaula. The other part is perhaps Rami Lewis is going to get warm for the Bluefish. He just got up from the bench and is walking towards the clubhouse.
So we're not sure. There's a little bit of action down there. This is more strategy than not for the infield, except Brock Peterson is talking strategy with the first baseman on the other side of the diamond, Chris Nowak.
With one man out, Julio DuPaula must face Manriquez, who's 0-3. One man out. Righty versus righty. Taps played a couple of times before he waggles the bat. Luis Lopez. About halfway, the next toss. Fastball in the inside corner, 0-1.
Good pitch by DuPaula. No chance of a bunt here, probably, Perry. Trying to get base knocks. Infield not thinking that way either. Nowak is not being held on by Peterson. No need to with a runner in front of him.
Bunting would be against the baseball grain. Pitch, foul tipped into the glove, 0-2. Luis Rodriguez made a poignant comment saying no batter is going to bunt with one man out unless it's for a base hit.
Right.
He could do that here and surprise everybody it would even be a bigger surprise with two strikes and one man out. The 0-2. Another poke foul on a slider.
Had some tight break on it. That was a setup pitch. I think Willie Upshaw came out and agreed with Machete behind the plate that your fastball will overpower him. We saw on the first two pitches, that's exactly what happened. Slider outside there. See if Rodriguez and DuPaul are on the same page with a fastball on the inner half.
No balls, two strikes, one man out. .130 on the East Coast. About 2.5 hours into the ball game. The 0-2, way outside on a heater. One ball, two strikes.
It's okay, you can get away with that. Even though Solomon Manriquez has one of the RBIs, one of the two today. He reached on the fielder's choice in the second. It was him and Shanks in back-to-back fielder's choice.
The 1-2. Swung on and foul tipped into the glove for strike three. Down goes Manriquez, two away for Scott Grimes. By the way, there are runners at first and second with one man out in Camden. Dwayne Pollock had another gem for Lancaster, but he's on the verge of losing his first game of the year, outdueled by Mike McGuire of the River Sharks. 7 innings, 2-run ball, 12 strikeouts for Pollock. McGuire, 7 2/3, 1 run, 7 strikeouts. RBI for Padron, and that was it. Just three hits for players that are in the game, and Eduardo Perez was replaced. Two out toss, fastball on the inside corner, 0-1. RBI from Cody Kirkland, and that is all that it amounted to, as Lujan is in the game for the River Sharks. Boyer at the plate for the Barnstormers. Runners at first and second in this contest, the 1-0 on its way from DePaul. A pitcher's duel throughout, the 1-0 waved that first strike. One ball and one strike. Pitchers have ruled the ball field, seems, over the last week.
At all levels. Seem to, especially here in the Atlantic League, not so many high scores. A lot of closely contested ball games, and we're in one here.
ERA's dropping, 0-2. Inside corner, strike three. Grimes flips his helmet and his bat away. He is irate. He just is talking with the home plate umpire, David Mills, and continuing to have the conversation. He's going to be fortunate if he doesn't get tossed from the game for his public outcry. No runs, no hits, two runners left on at the end of 7.5. Bridgeport is trailing 2-0. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish Broadcast.
Hey Bluefish fans, have you heard about the clubhouse? Conveniently located in Fairfield, it has an unparalleled team of baseball and softball instructors offering private instruction, camps, team training, rentals, and best of all, the chance to learn from an all-pro team including Mike Porzio, former MLB pitcher, and the Bluefish's very own Willie Upshaw. Open 7 days a week, stop in and meet our team, or call us 203-292-8700 and visit us at the web, theclubhouseCT.com, and get the Major League experience.
There is a different pitcher on the mound for the eighth inning as Corey Thurman's day is done. This call to the bullpen presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. Adam Thomas is on the hill, the former closer for the Road Warriors as he continues around the Atlantic League. He has some powerful stuff. 92, 93 miles per hour on the fastball and aggressively attacks the Bluefish hitters as Bridgeport brings up Eddie Rogers, Prentice Redmond, and Brock Peterson, 2, 3, and 4 in the order. Three of the four hits coming from the Bridgeport lineup from those three players.
For Corey Thurman, his final line, 7 innings, 4 hits, 1 walk, 5 Ks, 0 runs, 91 pitches, 58 of them for strikes.
The next pitch is on the outside corner, 0-1. Just 91 pitches. And yesterday, there was Derek Gordon, the 0-1 swipes outside, 1 ball and 1 strike, who was more efficient than Thurman through 8 innings. Thurman does not throw that many strikes, usually. Tremendous outing by the right-hander, though. The 1-1. Waved that for a strike on a slider. 1 ball, 2 strikes.
He was throwing strikes. You can credit that to the Bluefish swinging at pitches they maybe shouldn't be swinging at. But they were right around the zone where you have to figure out, decipher whether you really do want to swing or not. And that aided Thurman today.
The 1-2 from Thomas. A high pop to the right side, out of play, ball and 2 strikes. After facing all those floating changeups and floating changeups after floating changeup, I think the Bluefish bats pretty happy to see someone who throws harder than 80.
We'll have to see if they can adjust, though, Perry. Somebody that is a soft thrower replaced by a hard thrower, timing is always thrown off.
1-2, outside into the dirt. 2 balls, 2 strikes. Eddie Rogers had a single in the first inning. And that frame, the Bluefish had their chance. There was another chance in the third with runners at the corners and one man out, but a couple of lazy fly balls induced by Thurman. That ended the threat. 2-2, way outside, 3-2.
And the first inning was the best chance for the Bluefish. Rogers with that single. He stole a base, then Redmond walked. Then it was a dual steal. They're both sitting at second and third. Luis Lopez gets on with a walk as well. And nothing doing.
3-2, line drive caught. Ramon Castro stuck his glove up as the baseball tried to scale towards the ladder. One away.
Ramon Castro, talked to him earlier. I said, you got to stop making those plays over there at third. What are you doing to us? And he laughed. He said, oh, those are lucky. Oh, just luck on those. I don't know if there's any luck involved there.
Maybe the fact that the baseball's hit to him is luck because you never know where it's going. One out pitch is stroked down the left field line. It is a base hit as it rolls towards the wall. James Shanks has to play it out of the corner and delivers to the shortstop in Mr. Thurston. And with that double, it is only the second batter that has reached base in the last 17 official at-bats, with Brock Peterson representing the tying run at the plate. 19 home runs. Boy, number 20 could play a huge role in this game.
At this point, you don't want to do too much, though. You don't want to swing for a home run. You might end up putting it where you don't want to put it, and that's in somebody's webbing.
Many players are always thinking about being a hero. Peterson is not that way.
And there's a good lineup behind him.
The one-out toss. Off speed to the corner, 0-1. Peterson perplexed. Just nodded his head up and down and did not move his legs at all. Just his body language expressing that kind of disappointment.
Well, Grimes should take note out there at center field because that's the same pitch that he struck out on last inning.
That is true, the 0-1. Low That looked to be a similar pitch.
But that one skipped across the plate. Don't think Mills had any problem figuring that one out. Been very consistent, and so has Brock Peterson. He has been hot and hot could be. It is July, so I guess it's pretty fitting.
Three long line drives for Peterson today. The 1-1. Swung on line drive, base hit right center field. Redmond's rounding third. He's trying for the plate. The throw from Grimes is cut off. It is an RBI single for Brock Peterson. The Bluefish are within a run. It's 2-1.
Right on cue, Perry, not trying to do too much. He went with that fastball, and you saw how hard it was hit. It was tailing towards right center field. And if you're a right-handed hitter, when you put it up the middle, that's where it's going to go on a line drive.
One swing of the bat, and the Bluefish could be ahead after all the issues that they have dealt with today. Ramon Castro visits to the mound with Adam Thomas. There is nobody warming up in the bullpen, which means it's Thomas time against Luis Lopez.
You can credit the ability of the Bluefish pitching staff, Raymar Diaz and Julio DePaula combined, getting out of jams. In the last five innings for the York Revolution, they've stranded 9 base runners.
That is the first run that they've scored since the first inning of yesterday. The next toss on the outside corner, 0-1. That spans 7 1/3 innings today and 8 1/3 innings yesterday. 15 2/3 scoreless frames broken from the York pitching staff. Do the math, that's how successful they've been. Lopez stands in, waggles the bat, the 0-1. Swung on and lifted a long way down the left field line, but it carries towards the bullpen and it lands close to the hot tub. They haven't even landed in there.
That was close. It looked like it was going to get plenty out of play into the picnic area, but with that wind blowing to right field, it carried back and it basically hovered that fence line. It might have went right off the fence that barricades the picnic area from the field.
James Shanks misinterpreted the wind of that play. He may have had a chance to climb the wall to try to get it had he been closer to the fence, the 0-2. Fastball away, 1-2.
Either way, Lopez still alive, and that's what you need. Kennard Jones waits on deck, and he's had a tough day so far. He missed his opportunities as the Bluefish did early on.
1-2, high chopper past Castro into left field for a base hit. Peterson is at second base. Runners at first and second for Kennard Jones. And actually, there was runner moving over to third.
And his heads up base running by Brock Peterson. That ball gets by James Shanks in left field. And Peterson, it didn't look like he should be going, but what he didn't do, he didn't hesitate. He made his move and went, and it paid off.
And Mark Nation makes his way to the mound to talk with Adam Thomas. Boy, that was an interesting play. It was a high chopper pass. Castro did not look as if it was going to take a strange hop or anything, and Shanks misplayed the baseball, allowing Peterson to move over to third, and Peterson didn't stop, so no credit for the error. Runners at first and third now.
And
what
the Bluefish could not do early on is string hits. And here they go. 3 straight guys have reached on hits. Double by Redmond, couple singles, Peterson and Luis Lopez.
Not one time in this game when Corey Thurman was on the hill did the York Revolution give up more than 2 hits at a time. There was a hit and a walk twice in back-to-back plate appearances, but not one time where there's consecutive hits. And now the Bluefish with Kennard Jones at the plate have a chance to tie the game or even give the Bluefish the lead with an extra base hit. And there is action brewing down the right field line for the Bluefish. Jorge Julio is obviously out of the contest. The 1-out pitch swung on and served into shallow right center field. Scott Grimes on the move, makes the call and the catch, but Peterson cannot go from third base. It was too shallow of a fly, an unproductive out. Runners at the corners, 2 men dead, and it brings up Luis Rodriguez.
tough day for Kennard Jones. He's had ducks on the pond all afternoon and just not getting the breaks. That ball wasn't hit that well. Credit Scott Grimes for toying with Brock Peterson. But if they were being aggressive like they have been in the past and Peterson takes off there, you see where that throw ended up, Perry.
Grimes did not provide a great throw. It was well up the third base line, but
not to mention,
you have to assume a solid throw. Not a great one, a solid one.
Gets Peterson. It's true. But test him. You got to push it to the limit.
The two-out pitch. Curveball floats to the outside corner, 0-1.
The Bluefish need to plate this runner. Yeah, they have more cracks at it. This is one of the better opportunities they've had.
First and third with two men out. Next toss, slap, foul to the right, 0-2.
Louis Rodriguez had a single in his first at bat, and he had a hard line drive to Shanks in left, and Cade in his most recent AB in the sixth. Does not want to do the same here.
Right-hander's ready. Thomas releases, pitch, fastball high. One ball, two strikes. James Simmons waiting on deck if Rodriguez is able to reach base.
Had to check over at first. It looks like a pinch runner came in for Louis Lopez. I think that's Luis Figueroa.
Correct. A 1-2, way outside, two balls, two strikes. And this late stage of the game, Figueroa definitely has more speed, but he's been caught stealing in each of the last two games. All they want to do is prevent the sure out at second, maybe have a faster base runner in case there's a base hit.
Well, either way, there's a force now with two outs at first or second, so double play ball really isn't in order.
The 2-2, chop foul. That may have been ball three.
I think Louis Rodriguez spoiled one of his better pitches. You can set it up and get your fastball that you're looking for. Could benefit you.
His feet were moving a ton in the box. Off balance approach, fortunately for the catcher, stretches it to 2-2. The next look, swung and missed, strike three. That ends the inning. The Bluefish are unable to produce more than one run. They do it on three base hits. The Bluefish are going to the ninth inning, trailing 2-1. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we believe that sharing a pitcher of our great-tasting draft beer will bring friends together for a good time. And good is way better than bad. No one reminisces about the bad old days. If your guess is as bad as mine, then we're a couple of idiot faces. So far, so bad? Turn that frown upside down, Grumpy Pants. So why have a bad time when you could have a good time with a pitcher of Miller Lite draft beer? Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Perry Miles here with R.J. Garcia heading to the top of the ninth inning. And this call for the bullpen is presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. If we did not know any better about the Bluefish, we would have thought Blake Griffin was on the mound. but it is Jesse English. He looks similar to Blake Griffin.
You think so?
I do.
I think you're crazy.
He said that before, too. Jesse himself. He said several people have called him Blake Griffin before, but he does not like to get called it too often. He does not think that Blake Griffin is all too good-looking, but he still has the sponsors.
Well, guess what? They are similar because they dominate, and Jesse English has been dominating thus far. Last 17 and two-thirds innings, one earned run, one walk, 22 strikeouts.
He's been great. And he's one of the better personalities on his team, too.
He is a good guy, an avid golfer as well. Him and Dan Serafini went out yesterday teaching Gilbert De La Vera a little bit about the game. He's picking it up.
Gilbert De La Vera. What an interesting character. The pitch is inside, one ball, no strikes. Really nice guy, too.
Really nice guy.
But what an interesting character about the way he approaches the golf game. When the first time that I picked up the clubs, I shot a 10 on every hole except one. Whatever the max is, the pitch is swung on and driven out to deep right. Gathright took a late break on it. That ball is gone. Home run to right field allowed by Jesse English, and that breaks a scoreless string for English, and it's 3-1.
Hovman, only his fourth home run on the season, all coming with York. That one got out in a hurry and deflated any momentum that the Bluefish might have picked up last inning.
3-1 ball game as Joe Thurston moves in. Lefty-lefty usually never happens with English. The fastball turns high, one ball and no strikes.
All of a sudden, just like that, you can kind of feel the energy leaving. The Bluefish had it going.
And Ricardo Gomez warming up for the second straight day. 1-0, fastball high, two balls and no strikes. And this is one of the stats that I brought up yesterday that I'll bring up again today. This year, it has not happened where seven straight games have been determined by this close a margin where someone has a chance to pick up a save, whether it be the Bluefish or the adversary. Pitches on the inside corner, two balls and a strike.
For DuPaula, three strikeouts in an inning and two-thirds, 17 strikes, 24 total pitches, one walk, no hits. Pretty good.
Outside corner strike.
Pretty good work by him. He escaped two jams, one from Raymar Diaz and one self-induced after walking a guy and hitting a batsman.
Two balls, two strikes, another lefty for English to handle the pitch. Slapped on the ground towards short. Eddie Rogers bobbles for a moment and flips it to first. It's not in time. It's an E6.
Rogers getting kind of careless with the ground ball. He's anticipating these hops, Perry. You've noticed recently he's not staying down on the ball, and right there he didn't stay down on it.
Perhaps he knows more about the dirt than he does about anything else, this infield. The next toss from English. Waved after a strike from Castro, 0-1.
Castro's 0-4, not very often. He's been held off of the base paths. One of the better hitters in the entire league, and he's been doing it for a long time in the Atlantic League.
The 0-1 from English. Glove pinned against the thigh before he is ready. Glove settled at the belt. The next toss, foul tipped into the glove. 0-2.
I think English is mad. You see right now he might have that Blake Griffin demeanor on his face where he gets angry and just goes and bashes on somebody, except English is using it with an overpowering fastball.
Post-game show coming up following the conclusion of this ball game. The next pitch is served in the air to right field. Pretty well hit, Joey Gathright. Back pedal sprints, and it goes over his head. One hops off the wall. Gathright plays it in. but it is a double. Twice, Gathright has misplayed the baseball in the outfield in as many innings.
Tough for Gathright to adjust. Like I said, he's only had two career starts professional in right field. And you can see he is late to react to the ball, no question about it.
How about second baseman number 39, Andres Perez?
Andres Perez steps forward. And the Bluefish need to keep the margin. There was an error put on the board.
I believe that was for Rogers at short there.
Error, correct.
You can kind of feel the wheels coming off, Perry. It was a back and forth game. Bridgeport kept on staying alive, staying alive. Something halted quickly.
But just like this song, Staying Alive from the 70s, times have to move forward. And they have. Next pitch, inside and low. One ball and no strikes.
Here's another jam that a Bluefish pitcher has to work out of. This one's with no outs. Fly ball will give another insurance run with Thurston over at third. Castro at second.
1-0. Jam shot foul to the upper deck. One ball, one strike. The plan would be try to retire Perez without a run scoring, then possibly walk Fiorentino, but then you get to Nowak, and nobody's been able to retire Nowak. It's catch 22.
Yeah, I'm not sure if you really want to walk somebody to get to Nowak. Get it? Nowak? Nowak?
I did.
Okay.
Play on words, 1-1. Sliding inside, 2-1.
It's been a lot of that words with friends.
Hey, works.
Nah, I don't even play that.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, you never heard of the game? Words with friends?
I've heard of Scattergories.
It's very similar to Scrabble, except a bridge, smaller version.
2-1. High chasing fastball, 2-2.
Perez has been hitless today, too, 0-4. Saw what Castro did as he was staring at an 0-4.
Andres Perez has shown his propensity to hit the baseball with authority. Except for today, the results have not come to his liking. The 2-2 and smacks fouled on the left field line. Pulled his hands inside the baseball and drove it. 2-2.
These batters are smart. They'd lift one into right field and see if Gathright can field it.
Andres Perez is not that, quite that type of hitter, though.
Strictly pull guy.
Not a strictly pull, but he's more towards right center, which would play Simmons' roles. The pitch is swung on and missed. Strike three. Two strikeouts for Perez today. He's 0-5. As it brings up Jeff Fiorentino. Perez hits the ball much more to left and left center. Not to say that he couldn't do it to right center. He never hits it to right. Never.
Number two, Jeff Fiorentino.
Well, Fiorentino being a lefty, he's got a chance.
Well, he's a left-handed batter. 0-1 one batter on the Bluefish who does not often go to right field as a lefty. And that's Jones. Pitch, slap foul. Left side, 0-1. English is more of a power pitcher than anything else. But the problem is, if you're a power pitcher and you don't have great secondary pitches, it can be an issue, lefty versus lefty. You're supposed to use the body to be able to hide the ball well. The 0-1 slips away. One ball, one strike.
And English is more of a one-inning guy. Does not have that array of pitches as Perry was mentioning. But very effective not to show anything today with the two runners on, but coming in, as we had mentioned, he had been almost flawless.
1-1. Fouled off a mask. A ball and two strikes. A Bluefish are going to need two runs to tie and three runs to win it.
Depending on, in
the ninth inning.
Depending, exactly. We still got to get through this one. Infield is in right now, trying to cut off anything. Maybe get a play at the plate.
And right now, the runner at third anyhow is unearned, the 1-2. Fastball inside corner, strike three. Fiorentino goes down. He, like many of the Revolution players, furious. So now Ramon Castro's potential run is unearned. Because this would be the third out.
The defense, at least the infield, drops back into a little bit normal
first baseman number 38,
stance. And Luis Figueroa is at third after coming in and running for Luis Lopez in the eighth.
The two-out toss is a fastball low, 1-0.
No walk has reached in every at-bat. 2 for 2, 2 doubles, a run scored, a walk, and a hit by a pitch.
Bluefish had their infield in for the last two at-bats and got multiple strikeouts. Will they be able to record the final out of the frame? The pitch is an inside-out poke foul, 1-1. Whatever the Bluefish do, they do not want Nowak to beat him. He's already tried beating the Bluefish twice in this series, multiple home runs in this series and back-to-back games. Who knows, he might be due for one this at bat. 1-1. Breaking ball, low, 2-1.
No walk laid off that. Looks pretty good from here, must have just missed low.
It is a final in Camden. The River Sharks took care of the Barnstormers 2-1. Bases were loaded for the Lancaster against John Lujan, but were unable to come back. The 2-1 is a curve over the middle, 2-2. So the River Sharks are now 7-5. If the Bluefish fall today, they'll be 6-7. Southern Maryland in first place. They have a tough task ahead of them with Long Island. 2-2. Floats low, 3 balls, 2 strikes. English partially walking in front towards the dugout. He's miffed by the call.
Here's where you can be a bit careful with no walk. You don't want to give in. There is an open base. You only need one out. A hit's going to score two at this point. And if you want to test your luck with Shanks versus no walk, you just might.
3-2. Grounded sharply past third base into left field for a base hit. One run scores. Kennard Jones throw to the plate is not in time. We'll see how that is scored. It is ruled as a base hit. 2 runs come to the plate. It is 5-1.
Chris Nowak advances to second on the throw to the plate. And he has done the damage this series.
Sometimes having too much confidence in oneself can be a detriment to team results. Because if the pitcher is confident that he can record an out, and Nowak is as hot as he is right now hitting against the Bluefish, you may not want to challenge him. Pitch was up in the zone towards the middle of the plate, challenged him, and Nowak won. The 2-out toss from left-hander is lifted foul down the right field line, and in all likelihood, Raymar Diaz is day is going to end up in a loss in spite of 6 3rd innings of 2-run baseball.
That's a shame, and his ERA will definitely go down, which is a good thing, but he now would move to 2-9, barring a pretty serious comeback.
The 0-1, a high deep drive to left center, but James Simmons to left of center has room to make the catch for the final out of the frame, but 3 runs score in the inning. Only one of those runs is earned. 3 base hits, 1 runner left on at the end of 8.5. It's 5-1 York. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
At Miller Lite, we know there's only one thing baseball fans love as much as great Pilsner taste, and that's rooting for the home team. Because home is way better than away. Away is not where the heart is. Bringing away the bacon? Why? Bacon is delicious. Away is where you hang your hat? You should be hung up by your underpanties. So why root for the away team when you can root for the home team? With a great Pilsner taste of Miller Lite. Triple hops brewed Miller Lite. Taste greatness. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Shark tooth, screwdriver, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on. Grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, drumsticks, a motel key. Let's not talk about the motel key. Needle nose pliers, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. There's lots of things you can use to open the new Miller Lite Punch Top can, but you'll always get the same thing. A smooth pour with less glug. However you punch it, it's Miller time. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Shark tooth, screwdriver, skeleton key, golf tee from the golf trip that you never went golfing on, grill fork, tuning fork, fork fork, the lucky fishing lure you snagged Alan with, sorry Alan, drumsticks, chopsticks from the place you met that Dallas-based flight attendant, a motel key, let's not talk about the motel key, a spark plug, a domino, a house key. How do these things make Miller Lite from a can even better? Find out May 2012. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Lite wants you to win the greatest weekend that never happened. The ultimate Vegas weekend for you and a buddy. Just collect Miller Lite taste points for your chance to win one of 100 Vegas trips being given away this summer for the big weekend. So grab Miller Lite and seize the summer at tastepoints.com. It's that easy, and it never happened. It's Miller time. No purchase necessary. Open to legal U.S. residents 21 or older. Void in California and where prohibited. Sweepstakes begins 5-1-12 and ends 8-1-12. For details, how to enter and complete official rules, go to tastepoints.com. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. Great beer, great responsibility.
Miller time. Don't check your wrist or follow up with your supervisor. Because Miller time has nothing to do with when and everything to do with who.
What's up, Tommy?
Miller Lite is brewed for the guys you're proud to call your brothers. We'll always talk you out of getting that faux hawk. And never talk during your backswing. And when you've got your brothers and the light beer that tastes like a beer should, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time.
Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Now pitching for York, number 25, Ricardo Gomez.
Ricardo Gomez enters the game for the York Revolution. This calls to the bullpen, presented by Prudential Annuities. Prudential Annuities going to bat for our community. James Simmons moves forward. For the Bluefish, he has suffered some tough at-bats today. He's 0 for 3. Pop fly to third, a fly ball to center, and a ground ball to third. The next toss from Ricardo Gomez is swung on and missed. No balls and one strike. Gomez picked up his sixth save of the year yesterday in a 4-1 victory by the Revolution. A similar score today, 5-1. Three runs coming to the plate for the Revolution in the ninth inning. The next toss swung on and missed. No balls and two strikes.
Overpowering Simmons. Fastball up in the zone, and James can't seem to hold up. Game now just about past 3 hours. Camps have pretty much left the stadium.
The 0-2 from Gomez. Fastball inside, one ball and two strikes.
At least most of them got to see a run come across the board for the Bluefish. Would have been nice to play them a bit earlier.
Can never tell with baseball, and the Bluefish inconsistencies on the offensive side continue as the next toss is waved after a strike three call. 0-for-4 day for Simmons.
Simmons has had a tough series. Now he's 0 for his last 7.
Dowdy's 0-for-3. It was a 2-1 game entering this frame, and Gomez would have had a lot more difficulty trying to close out a one-run game rather than a four-run game. In theory, Gomez this year 2.11 ERA, 21 and a third innings, as the second-year member of the Revolution pours a strike over the middle, 0-1. 20 games, opponents hitting 125 against Gomez. The 0-1, fastball, tails inside. One ball, one strike.
Yeah. Doughty's still trying to get back in the groove of things coming back from that injury. Takes time.
0-1. A high drive down the right field line. Giving chase is Brandon Hovman, but he runs out of room as it sails above the Bluefish bullpen towards the Stonehenge, supporting the Long Island Railroad track. The Metro North Railroad tracks.
Yeah, we're in Connecticut, Perry.
Not in Long Island, correct. Lived there for a long time. The 1-2. Another poke foul to the right, a ball and two strikes.
Doughty said it's been tough trying to get his feet underneath him since tearing his hamstring early on in the season. Just that little testing it, see how it is. Got a couple days off after his first start back.
1-2, a high poke foul to the right out of play, ball and two strikes.
Said he was in a lot of pain after that first start on the most recent road trip. And I guess the plan was to take a couple days off in between the starts. He thought he was going to start yesterday after sitting out Monday's contest. But he got 2 days off in a row, and today he's had a couple of plays over at second base, but 0-for-3 so far at the plate.
There's no need to remove Luis Figueroa at this point. He's hitting the ball very well, and he's playing solid defense. Brad Dowdy's just recovering from injury. Need to work him slowly into the mix. The 1-2 from Gomez. Slides inside 2-2. Brett Doughty, a Gator, University of Florida, went as high as AAA baseball in his career. The 2-2 from the righty. Fastball dives to the dirt. 3 balls and 2 strikes.
Tough at bat by Doughty, fouling off a couple good pitches. Worked his way back to a full count.
Gomez is staring for the sign and receives the signal from the catcher Manriquez. The 3-2, slapped in the air to right field. Playable for Brandon Hovman, who scoops it up and makes the catch. Went to his side and used his glove underneath rather than over the top.
It was a tough break. Hovman had him played perfectly down the line. It was slapped and it was going to find the corner if a right fielder was playing normal depth and distance on a right-handed batter.
After reading the ball off the bat of previous few foul balls, it was intelligent for Hovman to be playing in that angle. 2-out toss to Joey Gathright, lands low, 1 ball and no strikes.
5th at bat for Joey, 0-for-4, couple of strikeouts. Looking to get something positive.
1-0 is a heater over the middle. 1 ball, 1 strike. He had not been playing for a little more than a week since his release from the Cincinnati Reds organization. Actually, it had been 2 weeks since he last played. 1-1. A slapper towards short. Moving forward is Thurston, and the ball took a strange hop and could not be handled. Wow.
It's going to go down as an error on the shortstop, Joe Thurston. And it's not just Eddie Rogers that's having problems over there in the hole.
About a shortstop. Number 24, Eddie Rogers.
If you trust everything to just come to you rather than aggressively attack, nothing's going to take place. You're not going to be effective.
You have to attack the ball. The golden rule that you learn is don't let the ball play you. You play the ball. Thurston let the ball play him there.
2 men out, Rogers steps up and he pops it up to the right side. Could be the game as Chris Nowak, and the catcher let the ball fall. Wow. 2 straight plays that are head scratchers for the Revolution.
No communication, rule number one in baseball. Anytime there's a fly ball, somebody's got to take command.
Rule number one, attack the baseball. Rule number two, make sure you're in front of the ball. Rule number three, communicate. They violated all 3 baseball sins.
No particular order, rule 1, 2, 3. You gotta communicate.
That too.
I think that's gotta be the first one. You gotta know where it is.
The 0-1 slides outside, one ball and one strike. You cannot call a team error on that.
Rogers had a single in his first at-bat. 0 for 3 since then.
1-1. Curveball low, two balls and a strike.
It could have been a huge eighth inning if you go back to it. He led off the inning. He hit a screamer right to Ramon Castro at third base. That was for the first out, and Redmond followed with that double and then the pair of singles by Peterson and Lopez. It could have been a totally different inning.
The 2-1 offering. Swung on, loopy line drive, base hit left center field. Eddie Rogers keeps himself alive as Gathright moves over to third. Runners at the corners for Prentice Redmond. By the way, the Bluefish, one batter away from sending the tying run to the plate. After all of that,
Redmond put a good swing together his last at bat. That double down the line started that eighth inning. He came around and scored. He's the only run so far.
Prentice Redmond has reached base three times, two walks and a double. Stands in the pitch. Slider on the outside corner, 0-1. This margin all created because the Bluefish were unable to take advantage of many opportunities today. The 0-1 fastball tucked inside, one ball, one strike.
They shouldn't even be here right now. Thurston on the play from Joey Gathright, that slapper that got hit to him with the air, and then the mental lapse on the first pitch to Eddie Rogers from Nowak and Manriquez.
1-1, grounded towards third, just goes foul. 1-2.
We'll make it up.
Lopez creating himself a little bit of pain. Just a matter of time. One ball, two strikes. Deal swung on and missed strike three. The ball game is over. The Bluefish had a rally going with runners at first and third, but were unable to bring the tying run to the batter's box. The post-game show continues right after this on BridgeportBluefish.com. Bridgeport loses the series 2 out of 3.
This one, best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week. So I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store. But stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No. The coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new two-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know. Super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how far, how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
Hey kids, it's not too late to join BB and all of his friends by becoming a member of the Bluefish Snappers Club. The Snappers Club is the newest club for all of the biggest or littlest Bluefish fans. As a member of the Snappers Club, you'll not only get free entrance on Snappers Club Day, but you'll also get a membership card to show all of your friends, plus a special t-shirt that will tell everyone you're a member of the club. After each Sunday home game, Baseball Bunch members will also be invited onto the field to run the bases, just like the Bluefish do. You'll even receive a newsletter that will fill you in on all of your favorite Bluefish players, along with all the news that BB Snappers Club has to offer. To join the coolest club around, call 203-345-4800 or go to bridgeportbluefish.com/kids/snappers to become a member of BB's Snappers Club.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish Broadcast Network. Harry Miles here. The final score, the Bluefish fall 5-1. Let's take a quick look at the scoring summaries today. In the second inning, Jeff Fiorentino single, Chris Nowak double, and then back-to-back fielder's choice ground balls, RBI for Shanks and Solomon Manriquez to give the Revolution a 2-0 lead. Bridgeport scored a run in the eighth, but it could have been a whole lot more than that. They had the tying run at third base, but a shallow fly ball to center field by Kennard Jones, and Luis Rodriguez struck out to end any hope. A double by Redmond, a single by Brock Peterson, which accounted for the only RBI of the day for the Bluefish, and a single by Luis Lopez to make him one hit closer to 2,100 for his career. In the ninth inning, Brandon Hoffman led off with a home run. E6 for Thurston, double by Castro, two-run single for Nowak with two men out to allow the Revolution to take this series 2-1. Revolution wins 5-1. Hoffman, three hits and a run with an RBI. Thurston, a hit and a run, as did Castro. Perez with nothing, a hit and a run from Fiorentino. Nowak, three hits, a run, and two ribbies. An RBI from Shanks and Manriquez. Grimes with two hits on the day. For Bridgeport, two hits for Rogers, a hit and a run for Redmond, three hits and an RBI for Peterson. Lopez with a hit and Rodriguez with a hit. Nothing else from the rest of the squad. The Bluefish fall 5-1, 5 runs, 11 hits, 1 error to 1 run, 8 hits, and 1 error. Castro with his 17th double of the year. Nowak had 2 doubles. He now has 16. Redmond with his 27th. Peterson with his 19th. Hoffman with his 4th homer. Hoffman, 27 RBI. Nowak with 2. He has 48. Shanks with 41. Manriquez with his first. Peterson with his 56th ribby of the season. Nowak was hit by a pitch, his 9th. Eddie Rogers stole 2 bases, his 12th. Redmond, 2 stolen bases on the year. Brandon Hoffman was caught stealing, his 9th. Thurston with an error. Rogers with his 16th. And York and Bridgeport left 11 runners on base. Corey Thurman wins his 9th game of the year. 7 shutout innings, 4 hits, 3 walks, 5 strikeouts. Adam Thomas with an inning, 3 hits and a run. With a strikeout, Ricardo Gomez, an inning and a hit, 2 Ks. Raymar Diaz, reciprocal record, 2 wins and 9 losses, 6 and a third, 2 runs, 8 hits, 4 strikeouts. DePaul, an inning and 2/3, a walk and 3 Ks. Jesse English, an inning, 3 hits, 3 runs, only 1 earned, 2 strikeouts. DePaul, a hit, a batter, his first. strikeouts in the day, 17 combined. Let's go through them. Castro with one, Perez with a pair, as did Fiorentino. Shanks with one, Manriquez one, Grimes two, eight for York staff. Gathright with a pair, Eddie Rogers one, Redmond two, Luis Rodriguez with a pair, and James Simmons with one. Six total walks today. Thurston, Fiorentino, and no walk. Redmond with a couple, and Lopez with one. Time of the game, 3 hours and 14 minutes from the ballpark at Harbor Yard as the Bluefish fall by a count of 5-1. When we come back on the Bluefish post-game show, we will wrap things up from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. You're listening to Bluefish Baseball on BridgeportBluefish.com.
Why do we love baseball? Is it the uniforms, the pace of the game, the mascots? Could be. Or could it be that what we really love is that baseball reminds us how we can all come out ahead when we work together, just like a good team? At Prudential Annuities, we understand that when everyone works together, good things can happen. That's why each year, we uphold a commitment to helping charitable causes in our community by pitching in financial resources and by enabling Prudential Annuities employees to help others through volunteer work. From conducting mentoring programs and helping homeless shelters to supporting health awareness and food banks, Prudential Annuities is more than a big company in Fairfield County. We're a big part of the community, too. Prudential Annuities, going to bat for the community.
The Prudential Insurance Company of America, Newark, New Jersey, and its affiliates. Prudential Annuities is a business of Prudential Financial, Inc.
This is Terry McGriff, pitching coach for the Bridgeport Bluefish, and you're listening to Perry Miles on the Bluefish broadcast.
A poem entitled Coors Light Summer. It's a Coors Light summer, hot babes all around. Backyard barbecues are where you'll be found. It gets pretty hot out, but it'll be all right because coolers are filled with ice-cold Coors Light. You step outside, mini skirts galore. Beer garden for the ball game, that's what's in store. It's gonna be a scorcher, but there's hope in sight. Refreshment awaits, Frost Brewed Coors Light. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this little ditty America's pastime. Woo! Summer's here and it feels pretty nice. Baseball and hot dogs and refreshment on ice. Some games are early, some are at night. But there's always a beer man with ice-cold Coors Light. He's the most reliable player in the game. All it takes is calling his name, so even if your team doesn't hit any dingers, you'll have Frost Brewed Refreshment at the tips of your fingers. Thank you.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
I call this one best girlfriend ever. It had been a long day and an even longer week, so I headed toward the kitchen, refreshment I did seek. But after swinging open the fridge, I saw the most horrific sight. Not a single cold beverage, not a single Coors Light. I grabbed my keys, it was time to hit the store, but stopped when I heard a knock at the door. It was my girlfriend, bearing gifts of Coors Light. Best girlfriend ever? You got that right.
Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Meet Ice Cube.
What's up?
Ice Cube is cold.
No. The coldest.
But one thing just might be colder.
Man, it better not be.
Coors Light has a new two-stage cold-activated label that not only tells you when your beer is cold, but super cold.
Yeah, I know. Super cold. It threw snow on me last time.
It snowed on you?
You better check yourself.
Ice Cube is cold, but Coors Light is super cold. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Behind everything you're searching for is something you're actually looking for. When you flip through the real yellow pages for a plumber, you're actually looking to reclaim your home from a renegade faucet. It's not just getting directions to a tailor with YP.com. It's looking your best for an interview. And it's more than finding a mechanic with YP.com on your mobile. It's getting your road trip back on track. Whatever it might be, there are more ways to search and more ways to find exactly what you're looking for with the real yellow pages, YP.com, and YP.com on your mobile, only from AT&T.
Mike Piazza talks about the Baseball Hall of Fame.
It just connects you with the history of the game and the tradition of this game and how important this game is to the fabric of society. It's something I used to bond with my father, and I will always, and I love to sort of teach my kids the history of baseball.
Preserving history, honoring excellence, connecting generations. Connect with Cooperstown at baseballhall.org.
We welcome you back to the Bluefish post-game show on BridgeportBluefish.com. Perry Miles here. Bridgeport falls by a score of 5-1 today. Great start by Raymar Diaz, but He is credited with the loss. He moves to 2-9 on the campaign as the Bluefish are getting ready for their next matchup with the Long Island Ducks. They lose 2 out of 3 in the series. Long Island has been struggling of late. Let's take a quick look at the scoreboard update courtesy of AtlanticLeague.com. The River Sharks defeat the Lancaster Barnstormers by a score of 2-1 as Dwayne Pollock picks up his first loss as a member of the Barnstormers. 7 innings, 2-run baseball. He's defeated by Mike McGuire, 7+ innings, more than 7 innings, and gave up just 1 run. Tonight, Sugar Land and Somerset, Southern Maryland and Long Island taking place from their respective venues. ESPN.com for the latest scores and summaries from around Major League Baseball. The Yankees and Mariners about to take place in a little more than an hour. The Nationals leading the Mets 5-1 in the bottom of the eighth with a runner at first. Boston and Texas slated to unfold at 8:05. Other games taking place. The Pittsburgh Pirates lead the Chicago Cubs 3-2 at the top of the seventh. Atlanta 5 and Miami 1 at the top of the sixth with a runner at second. Philadelphia taking care of Milwaukee right now, 3-1 in the bottom of the fourth with a runner at third. Minnesota has an early 1-0 lead against the White Sox, end of one. Kansas City and the Angels, San Diego, San Francisco this afternoon. Tampa Bay, Baltimore, Detroit, Cleveland, Oakland, Toronto, Dodgers and Cardinals, Cincinnati and Houston, Colorado and Arizona all later tonight. Couple of pieces of news from across the world of sports. Philadelphia Phillies have signed Cole Hamels to a $144 million deal, which guarantees that he will be there for the long run. The Florida Marlins, one day after trading Omar Infante and Anibal Sanchez, have gotten rid of Hanley Ramirez, the infielder, to the Los Angeles Dodgers. And so that is a huge trade for L.A. to bolster their offensive productivity. Alex Rodriguez suffers a broken left hand. He is out for 6 to 8 weeks. And that is all of the news from across Major League Sports. Thank you for tuning in to this afternoon's version of Bluefish Baseball. For more details on Bluefish Baseball, you can go to the website, bridgeportbluefish.com. You can send me an email, perrym86 at gmail.com, or follow me on Twitter, just me, P. Miles. Just me, P. Miles. The final score, the Bluefish fall 5-1, as Bridgeport will be taking on the Long Island Ducks tomorrow. 7:05 first pitch from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. Thursday, presented by Budweiser, as Gilbert DeLavaro is expected to take the hill for the Fish. 16 starts, 5-5 with a 3.80 ERA against Mike Lurie, the former Atlantic League Pitcher of the Year. 15 starts, 4-5 with a 5.44 ERA. For those that cannot make it to the ballpark at Harbor Yard, you can tune us in to BridgeportBluefish.com, 6:45 for the pregame show. Bluefish fall to 19-23 at home. They are 10-11 in the month of July, 6-7 in the second half. And they are 7-10 against York with a 3-7 mark at the ballpark at Harbor Yard. With no more games coming up against York at this venue, and they play their final 3 games at Sovereign Bank Stadium coming up less than a week from now. Thank you for tuning in. We'll see you at 6:45 tomorrow. Ta-da for now from the ballpark at Harbor Yard. The final score, the Bluefish fall 5-1. We'll see you later.